Ladies and gentlemen, are in. Let's find out where our grand final won't take place. Our bands begin with Coastline. We won't do that again. Chalet Cafe Clubhouse Skyscraper. That's not going to happen either. Oregon is out as well.
It's interesting to see Liquid remove two of the maps that they've just played.
It is, isn't it? And Bank is Liquid's choice to start on. They've won two games in the season, both their games of the season. On Bank, Penta haven't lost it this season, in the regular season.
Yeah,
well, let's be honest, Penta haven't lost a game for as long as we can remember, but maps, there's one or two along the way.
Yeah, and some.
We've talked about how proficient Latin America is on the big maps, especially Bank, so seeing Penta let it go through means that they're probably going to have something just like the other matchups that we saw where, you know, the team was like, oh, we thought we were going to confident on this one, and then we took it against them and they ended up getting beat.
Penta choose Border as a second, leaving Consulate as our decider.
I think Border is going to be where everything is decided.
You think it'll be 2-0, one way or another?
Yeah, I don't think we're going to see 3.
Why do you say that?
I really want to, but whoever gets the momentum on Bank, both teams are so amazing at Border.
Yeah. So whoever's got the wind
whoever
in their sails?
Whoever got the momentum on Bank, I think is going to take the whole thing.
Wow. Mm. What do you think, Fox?
Honestly, I think Bank is more favored in favor of
I know.
In the favor of Liquid, but Penta surprised us before. They've played Clubhouse, they've played maps that they haven't usually played, so.
And they've baited opponents and they've been very like, yeah, that's exactly what we wanted to happen.
Mind games.
Yeah, they've got them. They've got them in spades, they've got the gunplay to back it up. And Liquid though, Liquid are here having fun. And I'll show you a little bit later on a video that I've got about how Penta were on stage, setting up, getting ready for this, and Liquid went for a walk. That's how they prepared for this. They just wandered through the hotel, big smiles on their faces, chilling out. They are two very, very different teams on that stage, and it's really interesting to see which is going to work and which is going to come out. Do you want to say who you think is going to win it? I'm not going to make you.
Well, I mean, in the end, there's no bias here. They're both two of the best teams, and of course, Penta already has the titles under the belt. So just because they have that and Latin America hasn't got one, personally, I think it would be better for the whole scene if Liquid won. So saying that.
Yep, that's fair.
It'll be rough for Fabian if they don't win.
Oh, I'm glad that's your mind on this. Let's find out if it's rough for Fabian. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been amazing with us all weekend. We've had incredible viewing figures online and an amazing audience live with us at Atlantic City. You deserve a legendary final for Season 7 and Year 3. Emzo and Milosh, hashtag MyCasters. Let's do this with them and Liquid and Penta for the championship.
Bienvenuti a tutti! Signore, signore, it's me, Maestro!
Here we are, already released prior to the test server. We've got Maestro here to watch through his evil eyes as we watch this final.
It's gonna be. All right, let's get that show on the road. All right, okay. So, rematch. We've seen this exactly 1 year ago, as Matt mentioned.
A lot of rematch talk here.
Yes,
this
pretty much
final.
This entire thing. It shows that the pedigree of these teams will live on for much longer than what you'd even think as Rainbow Six grows. It's odd to imagine that exactly 1 year ago we were in the tiny studio in Katowice, and now we are in Atlantic City on a sold-out stage. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to ask you just to put your hands together for just a second.
To pray.
Because we're about to kick it off. Grand final time! Team Liquid versus Penta Sports EU Latin America Bank Map 1. Let's get the show on the road.
Will we finally get the upset against Penta? Fabian's here for the skins and the charms. Liquid's here for fun. Which one will win?
At this point, I just think Fabian wants some new shoes.
At that point, I think he needs some.
Yeah, interesting enough, he used to be a shoe salesman before.
I believe it, and he is doing his best to be selling those on stage. But in the meantime, got to play in Bank. And the interesting thing about Bank here is Liquid has won it twice, and they have 4 viable bomb sites they can play. And just to throw them off, Penta going to start on open.
Here we go.
What is considered the least viable of all 4 bomb sites, they're going to play. This is somewhat a strategy we've seen from some teams trying. I don't think it's worked as often as we would have expected it to, but it's just a very touchy defense.
Yeah.
It's one that is a great idea, but it depends on executing it well, and that depends on stopping the attacks from executing it well. But Penta love to throw off the other team, whether it be playing one-offs or be starting off on secondary bomb sites. This is how you throw Penta or Liquid off their game right off the bat, because their attack strategy is not set up for this at all, no matter how much studying they did of Penta.
Now, a few teams, as you say, have even attempted this. One of them would be Rogue, and it's not always a guaranteed site to go for. It is very much hit and miss.
If I was Liquid, I would expect, oh, maybe they'll throw CEO at us.
Yeah.
Nope.
Honestly, Penta even have tried CEO, and it works out fine for
absolutely
them. And they know how to counter all of these. We saw the Monty pushes. We saw how they played.
Yeah, we haven't seen a lot of those Monty pushes again. I would be interested to see if they're going to pull that out, because other teams seem to be failing pretty consistently at it versus Penta.
You know, the one thing I want to see is how Penta deal with Liquid, because Nesk has been an absolute god.
What's the price?
19 kills on one map.
We're not seeing Sexy Kick on Blitz. Is something wrong? Did he did he miss click?
Can we rehost BK? Can you give us some help here?
What's going on? He's actually just going to play Jackal? But as we talked about before, wow, Kanto, that is what you expect from Penta, who want to win this. Kill Nesk first. Easy for Penta.
First blood here on the dock of all operators. Of course, that's Kanta Rakete, the loan coming in from Ence, as Shate is not available here to play because of some personal...
Appropriate to have loans on bank.
Very much so. We saw that yesterday with loans being pretty much C4 bricks being thrown at you. Not the case so far, but Liquid reeling, Nest going down. We're talking about this actually with Kickstar in the back. Losing that top player on your team when he's been doing so well early on in the round makes him not be able to do much. And then it produces the morale of your team.
We've seen this from Penta before too. They were so good at shutting down Nest previously, and it completely decimated Liquid. I mean, I would say they're not as dependent on Nesk as they used to be, but after that last match, I would depend on Nesk.
Oh yes, very much so.
But they have Zig on the line, something he said he's very comfortable on. He plays quite a bit as well. PSK1 though on this Ying could be interesting. They're still trying to clear out Pengu here on Vigil. He's been proven to be a spicy Vigil quite often here. And then Kanto get on that dock. Could see him with some nice flanks. But Goga, who's been on fire, unfortunately can't land enough shots on that backpack. Zig taking him down, and then Sexy Kick trading, but Zig does get taken down by Junas.
Nicely done by Junas here as he refrags, at least taking down the Lion that only uses one of his E1Ds, of course Nesk being the first casualty. When you lose Pengu, you lose Goga, you lose the two roamers, but you still have the Bandit. Interestingly enough, there is no smoke for Penta to play around with here. Small Kanto cannot bring people back from the dead when they're in this position, that's for sure.
No, but he's not going to need to if he can just send the other people to the afterlife. And he's definitely going to be working on that, probably playing a bit more towards site. Junas we've seen be a bit pivotal in that as well, but Fabian playing on Mira is definitely a little bit different from what we saw earlier.
Here's the important thing, we mentioned it for every single site, taking control of the top floor is very important. Keeping that Hibana alive, a bullet, being able to open up the hatch. Unfortunately, with so little time left on the clock, Kanto will even open the mirror window to play his advantage as he sees the team of Liquid coming from the other side. Fabian turns around the last second as Kanto lands two more kills, gonna make it three. Bullet gets one, but 1 second on the clock. Kanto Rakete! What is this?
That was nearly an ace from
Wizard.
That's the first kill on Nesk
yes,
as well?
Exactly, a Kanto. 4K for Kanto Rakete, living up to his name. Kanto Rakete in Finnish means the carry rocket, and this is my friend.
He is proving that sub has a different meaning, apparently, to Penta.
it's more of a footlong at this point.
Yeah, I'm a little worried for Shate at this point. I'm not sure he'll be invited back.
Sorry, Ville.
Unfortunate, but much like they did with Nesk, I feel like Liquid just need to start shutting down Kanto at this point, but if he's playing site, good luck getting a pick on him, although he got a pick of his own right at the beginning of the round. So, a great start for Penta, but a little bit of a rough one towards the end. Kanto, though, just great, smart play, working the angles, using his ACOG, playing his armor, and then, you know, just making sure that he's able to get all the shots he needed because he knows where they're going to approach from. That is one of the upsides of playing that defense there, especially with such little time left. You know all of their angles of approaches, and using the mirror window like that from the other side completely worked to his advantage with that ACOG.
This is as big of a clash of titans as it can be. Not only is it the two best teams in their own region, Penta, of course, being the best in the world technically now after Six Invitational, Team Liquid being top in their region as well in Latin America. Well, here you have a face-off of two huge players, Kanto Rakete and Nesk. And so far, it's Kanto 1, Nesk 0.
Well, so far, they're showing off a plant denial party here downstairs from Liquid. They're bringing a lot of C4s, smokes, and the yokai. And then, of course, you've got the roam potential of Bullet, although we've seen a lot of roams that will return to site, especially as Vigil, for whatever reason, it just seems like Vigil is one that's willing to come back to site a little more than we see often from some of the other players that will just get forced into corners and try and fight it out because of the CQC capabilities of that Scorpion. But we're going to see Kanto playing what he's been playing a lot here. And Fabian back on Twitch, definitely good, as well as Goga on Thatcher, or I mean Thermite, who's been extremely effective all day. So this is the lineup that's been winning them match after match. So this should be a tough one for Liquid to hold. But they've got to manage time is the thing here, because we've seen Penta have been great about time management, about clearing roamers, about being ready to fight Sight as soon as possible. Liquid, Bullet especially, needs to burn some time here. And Nesk, unfortunately, is just going to be burning nothing but air as he dies. And Pangu finishes off Bullet. No roamers left. What a start for Penta with nearly 2 minutes left.
Flashback to a year ago at Katowice. Well, you know what? Early on here, Nesk being shut down. Penta able to figure out where he is. Fabian taking damage, but that is no problem here.
Yeah, problem with roaming here, though, is they're almost always in the same spots. Yeah. They're either in CEO or they're in Archives. It's not hard to find them. I don't know if you really need a Jackal. I mean, when it comes down to it, you're going to pinch them in almost the exact same spots. You just need it to be able to get a more precise location, and that is unfortunate for Liquid.
Most teams will bring a Jackal if they see that they're struggling to deal with their opponent's roaming. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it wouldn't be their initial pick. And you know, Liquid, in the first round, they were pretty much afraid of the roam, but they were able to clear it very effectively. However, they didn't really expect the anchors to be even stronger than the roam.
Especially when you have Junus, of course, able to spot out the Vigil as well. That really does not help on trying to hold that. But Zig does trade it back before he's slaughtered for the second kill by Pengu.
All the smoke, at least Sexy Cake and PSK are alive. Sexy Cake will play in the back here of the gold vault. It's PSK fall back. He'll spot the drone of Yunus and struggle a bit to take it out as his phone is ringing. Unfortunately, we have not introduced side buttons to turn it off and put it on mute. Pengu spraying right in, trying to take down the mirror window as well that is set up to look through into CCTV. He will watch that red hallway, because he has nothing else to do. This is pretty much the one rotation spot that Liquid has against the four of Penta. But there you go, Yunus gets one. The C4 will miss it, PSK. Be forced back. Four players still alive, of course, for Penta. They'll go for the plant, and there we go. It'll hit right on the floor. See where the smoke died. Try to go for the spot, but Yunus using the opened holes to his advantage. And as we always repeated, Devin, these
they work both ways. That's right. Unfortunate. They definitely played the entire defense against them. I like the way they even had those two X-Cairo holes they set up in the wall facing into Red Hallway from the garage. I mean, you had the Echo who was there, supposed to be holding garage, just could not do so. Fantastic play by Penta, starting off very strong. And now this is a team we talked about earlier. Sometimes we'll start off a little slow, but we saw what happens when they start off with two rounds against Rogue. It ends up being a short map. So Liquid are going to have some more fun that involves more killing if they want to stick in this all the way to three maps the way they're going so far. Fabian finally going to be back on that Legion we like to talk so much about, but he wasn't showing us earlier. Kanto going to be on Vigil that we have seen from him quite a bit. And Liquid bringing out what they brought the first round, except for changing up Nesk over to the Ying.
So. Which is definitely a different thing. Nesk has been the usual suspect on the Ash.
Well, I mean, it was a good pick. The problem was obviously running into Kanto's bullets does make it a little bit of a short-lived play.
I think this is Liquid basically needing to adapt just like Penta does and play their own game. They cannot keep forcing the one super aggressive player, because this might have worked with Millennium. It barely worked, actually. But with Penta, it won't. We've seen it last year. 100% it'll be a repeat, so it's a good thing, in my mind, that Liquid changes Nesk off of his super frag role, and they'll put him at least on the Ying, where here, he'll have some sort of support role to play, as well as the kills, of course, with the Candelas being so important for you to push in and possibly zone away your opponent.
Well, unfortunately for them, they completely read into the sewers push, and they're ready for it. You see the Thermite rotating, getting ready to come down and blow the wall if they can get it, but two people contesting. You're used to fighting someone behind servers, but two people like Pengu just fast peeking as much as possible is going to be hard for Nesk, because he could definitely fast peek and get one of them, but two of them, they might be wasting a lot of time that they didn't have to rotate all the way around the map, and that's going to cost them big time. But Pengu does eventually rotate off. We've seen him stand up on the desk sometimes for angles on that, but he's not going to do so yet.
Reminder that Penta does not have a Mira, and they're defending downstairs.
Yeah,
now that is as unusual as it will ever get. Now, Sexy Cake being damaged, very low on HP now from the C4 thrown
barely
below him.
Away with it. Yeah, they're actually going to open up that server hatch, too.
To Riccetti, he's going to try to get the angle. He'll spray take that bullet. That is huge now. And can he get the second? Yes, he can. Kanto, how do you do this? That's two now down. That's the Jackal. No more smokes to combo with the Ying and the Habana down. So now, destroying those reinforced walls are a bit more difficult. And even the hatches are going to be not impossible to break down because you need still the Thermite to act on the server wall.
It's a good thing they had double breachers at this point because otherwise this would be very difficult. I mean, the mirror, lack of mirrors, wow, as I say that, Zig though, triggers a line, kills two, but gets traded, but just still worth it as it's now a 3v2.
And well, the other two are just going to try to push in from the source.
Here we go.
The tunnel, PSK and Nesk. We've seen them both clutching up for the team before. Three players left alive for Pentek. Kanta, Riccetti on half HP. Goga taking damage as well. You see there, they will detect the fact that Kanto is downstairs as well. PSK will set up here to open big hack
at least
hole.
They have some time. But that gives time for Kanto to rotate for a flank as well.
Now Goga on the smoke. That's an oddity. But here, the Candela is going to get thrown, but shot from the top. It's Jonas and Goga that'll clean up the round. How were they able to rotate all the way back up? Well, just because there's not enough manpower, and this is why you couldn't have rushed through here.
Yeah.
These hatches will always work again.
What a shutdown. They were so ready for that sewer push, and you could tell Liquid were not ready with a backup plan. That's the problem with committing to a sewer push, of course, is that if you decide to go with the backup plan, you've already probably wasted a good 30 seconds at most, and you're not clearing the map in the meantime. You're not getting map control because they're not coming sewers. You can't take control of sewers and say, like, oh, well, now we've got Flank Watch here. They're not going to run outside and jump down there. So that is a dangerous game to play. But if you can play it, obviously, you can get that Thermite in. We've seen some of these teams rush in with a Thermite and a Glass. Cool, it works great, but two people, tactical pause needed here to be like, we're three rounds down. Sensei calling some plays, hopefully making some smart decisions for his team here. Probably telling them, have fun, Zig.
And this is, of course, the first season finals where we do add a tactical pause that can be used once per map, per team, for 60 seconds in total where you can talk to your coach. Of course, usually you can talk between all the players, that's one thing, but being able to talk to your coach and see the perspective of somebody that is outside of the action and that knows how to dig deep and analyze the mistakes and the good things that you're doing. That is the important part of the timeout. And already, first one used. Perfect timing, actually, because we're at 3-0. If it would have been at 4, it would have been much more difficult. We'll see, though, how this helps Team Liquid.
Still absolutely could turn into a 5-0 here. You see PSK opening up a bunch of the wall so that they can't go with a Thermite play on there. Still possible to do, but it's much, much trickier. So Goga's going to have to really work with his team because he doesn't have any soft breachers to open that up. It's going to come down to, can he get it on there with a tricky play, or is he just going to go for the other wall first by the servers and then switch around for the wall PSK's opening up? It's going to be tricky, though. This is a good play by Liquid reading into that, especially since they don't have anything to directly counter that. They do have some nades that can be used to clear that barbed wire and may also open up some more of the wall enough to crawl through from Junus. So it's not completely terrible, but it is not going to be as easy as it was before.
With the wall being open like this, though, you can very much use both grenades. The first one will land right into the side. It'll open up most of it. And the second one being aimed more at the barbed wire.
And
it will very much clean it up.
Thankfully, no ADS for them to deal with. No Jaeger being played. And that, we actually have seen a lot of... Wow.
Oh, what is this? Zig? No! He goes down as Fabian turns around. The captains will butt heads early on in the round. Fabian nearly escaping this one. And more than enough time for a reset.
I'm not sure that that's what Sensei told him to do this round. I'm guessing that was a decision all of his own.
Sensei the Sensei?
Yeah, that was... Not a great play, but Zig, being the IGL, will be calling out a lot of plays, taking advantage of his position now, watching all the other four players remaining. Nice play there by Junus, getting a little bit of damage there potentially, but it's not going to do a whole lot. However, now Bullet has to worry about being tracked, and this is going to put him in a tough position. Not only that, but he's got some phone calls, some missed voicemails that are going to be a little bit of a problem for him as he gets droned out as well. He is just under all kinds of fire. If only they had a lion to hit him with as well. Unfortunate for him, but he's going to live through it. That's the important thing here, and now Junus has to go for the flank.
You know, Kanto, of course.
Ooh.
We're going to call it the signature Dokkaebi here.
There we go.
Finally, We can see the phone being hacked, so you can go through all the cameras. We don't have a turret for Maestro yet.
But Sexy Cake's camera is going to be very useful
what
now.
Is, how is he alive?
No, it's I think it's because he chose full health in there, unfortunately. Okay. A little bit of a trick. He looked like a zombie for a second there. Nope, he's going to stay alive. Phone calls are still coming out, though, and they're struggling with that. And he doesn't have time to answer it.
They know exactly where he's at. The C4 is going to get thrown out right on the Havana, and no, it'll miss. No, Pengu's still on the floor. Kanta Raketti, though, will clean up Sexy Cake from the other side. But Pengu is down on the floor. They can pick him up. They have not reset Fabian, though, but at least Pengu will be back up at 50% health. Nesk and PSK, last two alive, and they're sitting tight on the site here. Opening things up.
That's a lot of openings to watch, though, with so few people left alive. Of course, Smoke and Mirror are going to be the last two, but that's too many angles.
And that's the question now. Where will Penta go for? Will they go for the back? Will they go front? It all depends. Counter Rocketti maybe expecting one player to roam around.
He's getting a lot of use out of that laptop.
There we go. Fabian will be reset. What I'm expecting is at least one or two players rotating around and playing either from the stairs or from garage. And there you go. You spot it. Jonas is coming around from the side. And he hears the smoke rattling his SMG 11 in the garage. Just Ness gets one. Go for the spot here, but at least pulling them back. Nest will get one on Goga as well. And now a 3v2. I'll make that a 3v1 as PSK is down on the floor. 16 seconds though left and
15 seconds left.
Unable to drop here. Nesk bit the wishful thinking there with the shotgun and Penta. Round four on the board. Kanta Raketti somehow surviving at the end through the shotgun shot. Will be alive to spray.
I'm starting to wonder if the entire point of the team of Penta is to have four people to push into Kanto. At this point, it's just, he's just this Venus flytrap. Everyone just baits into him. And that is exactly how you play with someone that you know can do really well on their own, frag out when they need to, play the operator roles that they know how to play. You know how to play your strat, just push into it. And they're capitalizing on that.
The thing is, that role of aggressive fragger back in the day used to belong to Pengu, especially on the attack. Well, there was a point where he played the Blackbeard and then the Ashe, and now he's just back to playing really whatever.
He is so flexible, though, and that's the thing, though. It's really working out for Penta. Just play, play whatever, Pengu. Play whatever we need.
We'll see. Even he's playing the Habana, of course, great operator for him. 10 kills, 10-0 in four rounds.
Located by attackers.
Okay, we said Nesk is an absolute god. We said that Waka from Norarengu is an absolute god. But this, this is a whole different level here.
If they win, I say let Kanto pick up the trophy first. and that's not to denigrate the other guys. Goga and Junis in particular have been showing up a lot today. But still, it's so impressive to see a guy is, you know, just a few days to practice with, as maybe he puts it, five days.
They spent 5 days in Berlin basically playing strategy games.
Yeah. We are going to see our first CEO, so we'll see if these strategy games pay off here for Penta. Something I said I would have expected maybe a little bit earlier, but Liquid also have strategies for CEO in open area, so they should know how to attack them as well, but it didn't seem to be the case necessarily for open area, although that was a pretty close round. Now this is going to come down to, can they pick up Nesk, who's back on the Ashe again early in the round? And we still have yet to see a Sexy. You know, that's it. That's why it's 4-0 right now. Sexy Cake has yet to play Blitz. That's got to be it.
Yep. So far, no ballroom blitz. Kanta Raketti is looking for a quick peek. Of course, he saw it
on the drone.
11-0 now for Kanta Raketti. And you know what? That damage, it doesn't do anything. He can just heal it back. He can play behind. He can play in the elevator shaft.
He's got like three places to go, just 5 feet away. This angle gonna have to be held by PSK for so long, and now you've only got three people to actually do anything inside the building at this point. Does drone him at least, but that is the end of that shock drone. At least it did its work getting the window open and that forced Kanto into tight spot. But now Sexy Cake waltzing into bullet spraying from every angle.
Oh, Jonas as well holding the stairs seat.
Thanks.
They open it up here. Fabian will help out Kanto and I'll bring him down. The diffuser, of course, is on the floor. He'll get the spot, and there we go. Finally, Kanta Raketti, four rounds, well, the fifth one into the game. He'll die. And that is to Nesk. We've seen them both butting heads time and time again.
That needs to be Nesk's job at this point, is to try and shut down his opponent as much as possible.
Well, Nesk will walk on up here as he's back again on the Ashe.
Ooh.
Just in control of the spiral staircase, but Pengu will try to contest, and Jonas is only on the opposite side. Stairs, the white stairs.
Penta's doing a great job playing it back after they peek.
Oh, you can't do that here, Nesk.
Nope.
He'll go down. He's still not out. And there you go. Oh, there you go. Fabian will get the kill. Unfortunately, when the team is playing so far back, unless you have a shield or something to protect or smoke or anything, it's not going to happen. But Sexy Cake will get the kill on Pengu. At least refragging, but he's going to be down to 35% health. Now, Fabian taking a bit of damage as well. 3v3 situation as Jonas is holding still on the left flank. Well, the right one in this case.
And keep in mind, this is match or map point.
Well, spot him. There you go. Bullet finally reversing it with his FAMAS on Fabian. Take him out, though. Second one as well, PSK, and now it is all on Jonas, who can't hit it. Liquid will come back swinging 4-1, but that's the first round out of three more that they need to get to even take it to overtime.
I think they needed the pressure at that point. They needed to be that close to losing this map because this is their map pick. They needed to be like, we cannot drop this. They need the laughter and the jokes they were mentioning earlier, and maybe they were joking about being that close to being done and moved on to map two. But they are going to go for Tellers, and that should be a little more solid of a defense than Open Area or CEO perhaps. But CEO was not the worst idea. It just seemed like they were able to finally get the picks they needed towards the end because a lot of the defense depended on the plays they were making towards those spiral stairs. And it was almost just brute force that Liquid were able to take that, just pushing continually up those stairs, using even the defensive position that you saw set up by the defenders themselves, by the shield of Kento or Kennedy there.
Yesterday, I was talking to Nesk for a brief minute, and I told him, Nesk, you finally beat Fnatic. And a Fnatic as an org hits Nesk real hard as he lost three times to them in the grand final in 2015 alone. Now, he's in, he can finally make it through. Now he has to face Penta, an even bigger juggernaut in Siege. It's going to be a long way up this mountain. Well, at least no Molten this time for Penta. Liquid bringing Zig on the Echo yet again. And yeah, now they're going to play in Archives.
This seems like more of their setup for downstairs, but instead of a smoke, they switched out for a Legion and an Ella there instead of a Vigil. So they are switching it up a little bit, but it still seems like a lot of, you know, you expect an Echo and a Mira a little more for the downstairs. So where's the Valkyrie? But they've got some good C4. They've got some good ability to deny plants. However, it depends on defending this top floor, as we've seen from a lot of teams. Once you get that, I mean, they don't have a Buck or a Sledge or anything that's going to really open up, because they don't bring a lot of soft breachers on Penta when there comes to attacking Bank. For whatever reason, they just don't. You're not seeing, for example, Junas bringing Zofia a lot. Instead, he's going with the IQ, which I think has been paying off for the most part. So they do have some grenades to work with in terms of being able to breach, but it's a little trickier. At least he's getting some good mileage out of that Shutterbug.
Jitterbug at this point.
Especially when you watch Pengu holding an angle.
Well, now they're just going to be taking control of the top floor, taking down as many cameras as possible. Of course, Sexy Cake playing the Valkyrie, which means you still have to deal with all three cameras that can be played in Bullet, and Sexy Cake will be the two playing upstairs. Oddly enough, it is the Legion that's going to be playing upstairs, as Pengu has taken 25% damage early on in the round, as Yunus' drone will finally get taken down, but he knows Skylight is open, he can move in, and doesn't really have to worry about a quick peek against him.
Now, the upside to having the Legion played outside or upstairs is if he got his mines downstairs or by the doors to stop people coming in, like sprinting in the doors, he could be really useful upstairs in continuing to slow down this push as long as he stays alive, but he's playing too aggressively on these windows.
Bullet will be called as Kanta Raketti using the logic bomb to his advantage here, giving Pengu a bit of information. Did he spot the angle below? No, he did not. Bullet will come back up here. Oh, find the shot on Pengu.
Just barely.
No, it's a good thing penguins can fly. Yunus will go up. He'll be hit by the Legion trap. Now, will Bullet get the second one? No, he will not. That'll be Fabian taking down Sexy Cake. As at least one of the two that are upstairs will get taken down. Bullet being shot from the back, and Yunus take him out. 3v4. Penta have complete control of the top side. And, you know, we talk about bringing a Buck, etc. Well, here, you got Fabian that's bringing the Jackal. And what does he have? He has the same shotgun secondary as
here. Yeah, he's got that shotgun to be able to open up, assuming he gets into that room, as he's a little more focused on the loan office and lobby at the moment. And Nesk could be a little bit of a problem here, but Goga carrying the diffuser here. Could be getting set up to go downstairs at some point and open up the wall for a potential plant. There are a couple walls he could use, but there, the elevator, he does check it, as he was the one to play it last round.
It's not something that everybody will check all the time. We've seen it before, where it costs pro teams the whole map. Zig will get one more on Goga.
They've lost both
picks up, and Zig will get the second. The Bearing Nine being put to work here. Kanta Raketti gets one more. Zig has to carry this here. or else Liquid will go, but no, Jonas will get the final shot, a headshot on the IQ, and a 5-1 victory in map number one, Penta Sports. The second one, you know what? It's Border.
Yeah.
It's an even better map for Penta.
Yeah, well, except for against Rogue, apparently.
Well, yeah, actually, very good point.
Now, I imagine Liquid, hopefully we're watching that match to see some opportunities they might have on that map, but you know, Penta, we're going to be thinking about those as well. How did we lose our map? We're going to shore those weaknesses
13-1.
Up.
13-1. How do you play six rounds and get 13
here's,
kills?
Here's the funny part.
In pro level.
That's low because they only played six rounds.
Yeah.
Had Liquid been able to get more rounds, he would have been up potentially over 20 the way he was playing.
Yeah, we'll remind you that when Ness got his 19 kills, that was in a total of 10.
Yeah. So he is definitely showing that he is by far the Nesk of his team right now.
Somebody needs a raise.
Yeah.
It's very much the case.
Either way, though, they took Bank by storm. That was definitely a bank robbery from Penta. 5-1, and it was a tough one for the one that Liquid even got. However, Liquid, assuming they're still in that mentality of playing for fun, should not let that get to them. They should not get the tilt. They should not be in a situation where they're just going to take this lying down. They should just have some fun on Border.
For me, I look at Bank, and I just see it as basically, instead of calling it Ocean's 11, I'll call it Fabian's 5.
Yeah, Fabian's 5.
Because that was pretty much it. It was a complete robbery.
Can we swap him with George Clooney, though?
I don't think.
Just once.
I don't think George Clooney is as attractive as Fabian.
No, but maybe he's good at Rainbow Six. We don't know.
Yeah.
Give him a chance.
He is married to a very fantastic Lebanese lady, actually, which makes me very happy. Tidbits. Fun facts.
We learned so much here at Rainbow Six.
Yep.
But they are getting set up. I imagine Sensei going to be doing a lot of thinking here for his team. Shaz still calling out stuff as well. They are definitely not going to slow down any point soon. Penta are definitely taking advantage of their aggression. Right. And a lot of that is definitely relying on Kanto, but it seems like most of the team is showing up regardless of Kanto taking all the kills.
No, for people in the crowd here that were not at Six Invitational, hopefully we'll see you next year. However, at Six Invitational, we actually got sort of a wave going through the crowd. Now, I wonder if we're going to be able to make waves here. A bit of a throwback to Fox.
Yeah, we didn't have Coastline next.
Unfortunately. But maybe we'll make some few waves here for Team Liquid, because they need to crawl back into this one. They've got a lot of work ahead of them on Border if they want to take it to map 3. And this is, as you mentioned, the map that Penta lost to Rogue.
Mm-hmm.
Very, actually, convincingly for Rogue. But historically speaking, Penta have been very comfortable on Border.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great map for them. So it's no surprise to see they still want to play it. It was just a case of maybe they weren't playing to their full capability. Maybe Rogue were just playing in a certain way they were not expecting. But that can be the case with these Latin American teams. They play so different than a lot of the regions. But the interesting thing is what Zig mentioned during his interview, talking about how much they'd played with Penta at boot camps, played in Brazil together. So they do know each other fairly well. In the case where it's not like, oh, we're going to be so surprised by the way Liquid play here, maybe they'll take this back. However, I don't think we're going to get like quite the 5-0-5-1 that we saw on Bank, despite this being Penta's map pick. I just feel like Liquid have a lot more in them and just weren't warmed up yet. Although they're actually coming the freshest off a match, because they just played a match against Millennium, whereas Penta played much earlier in the morning,
yep.
Had time to rest, had time to go over things with Shaz. And that's the thing, is going back to Border again, they had all that time to review what they'd done against Rogue, to review what Rogue did well against them, and there's the wave for Liquid.
This is definitely not synchronized swimming, that's what I can see.
Well,
maybe we'll get that improved for later, but ladies and gentlemen, let's see how this one pans out. Team Liquid, I mean, at this point, they might as well be like oil and water with Penta, because right now they're looking pretty in a pretty difficult spot, but let's get the show on the road. Map number 2, possibly our last one. Maybe if Liquid can take it to the third, Penta Sports versus Liquid on Border.
We've had so few 2-0s that to go with a 2-0 here in the grand finals would be a bit disappointing, to say the least, especially with how well Liquid have played during this entire weekend. So, I mean, we'll see. We're going to have actually Bullet channeling a little bit of Kanto there. I mean, it's surprising to see that Operator coming up quite a bit more than it used to be. I mean, Kanto has been playing it, I'd say, more than anyone else.
Yeah, so far. Yeah, there's basically three players, especially in Europe, that will play it. Wen showed that before. It's KS of 1UP, not 1UP anymore.
Attackers have discovered the location.
We have Kanto Raketti, of course, Ence, Penta, whichever you may choose. And lastly, Liven, that we saw playing with Millennium in our previous matchup. And the one player that's been able to play it to maximum effect, to say the least, is Kanto Raketti.
Yeah. He's absolutely been using both the guns well, and that's the trick, is if you can get the hang of the DMR, the SMG's also a beast,
yep.
And then it's a bit more like you were saying about Vigil, where you've just got two good guns instead of one good gun and a pistol. But they are going to be going with Vents again as their starting bomb spot, something I was talking about earlier. It just seems to be, and I don't think it's throwing teams off, because you get to predict it at this point, because they've done it consistently during the season, during the matches this weekend. They're not trying to be unpredictable or crazy here, they are just so comfortable defending Vents. Although we saw Rogue kind of dismantle Vents' defense last time when all five of Penta tried to defend it upstairs and were forced to rotate down after losing a lot of players. So Liquid could potentially do something similar, but Nesk seems a little concerned by this hole here. A little bit too much focus on it. Unfortunately not resulting in anything other than him running around and trying to figure out what to do at this point. So it doesn't seem like they have a solid strat for this attack. I have to imagine they were expecting Vents, but it seems like maybe their lineup was set up for a different stack.
Kanto Raketti, yeah. He's on the mirror. We've seen him against Evil Geniuses, clutching round after round.
Yeah. If anyone's going to get these kills right here, Tim and Junus has played this spot so well as well. And I imagine it's going to be very difficult to get that wall open. I would almost just go with, ooh, that C4, unfortunate. I would almost go with an offensive take, just because Junus is going to hold that to a T. Although, nice play by Sexy Cake getting that down, and that is going to spot him. Potentially, there
oh
we go.
No, Zig comes in, you get one, but the lineup for Kanto. That's two kills that are stolen later on by Pengu as the two were down. But the wall will still get open. You see the Thermite running all the way back as he goes back into CCTV, but Bullet is ready as he uses the destroyed mirror window to his advantage. Pengu lining up very close. Kanto Raketti's trying to stay alive, but Sexy Cake with the cross angle. 3-3 now. As Goga will go down as well, and there we go. Now it is all left to Fabian. The IGL Bullet will land the kill on Kanto Raketti, making sure he can't claim too many kills, at least in this map. Liquid off on a fantastic and solid start here. Fabian has to try and clutch this one out versus the three, not impossible. He does have a shotgun as well if he needs to open the hatch and CCTV to drop back down. But be making any sounds. He's going to try to come in from behind, but he's heard and Sexy Cake turns around. They'll win the round though with a V308. Lion will clutch it.
It's funny, we usually see Zig on Lion, but I have to say Sexy Cake was so much more effective with a nice 3K. I would put him on Lion over Jackal any day and maybe find a different position for Zig to play just because Sexy plays it so well. I mean, obviously it's not Blitz, but he is definitely rocking that Lion. We'll see how well they do on defense though. Is they're going to go with a traditional defensive spot up Armory, Lockers, Archives, with a very traditional defense. The usual old school lineup with the addition of Mira, who was the only newer operator in here. Otherwise, it's all OG operators. Zig playing Pulse, which he does so well. I imagine could play it flexibly. He's one that will play a somewhat aggressive Pulse, so he might not even be downstairs. He might play aggressively up in the small office, or he might play behind a half wall for all we know. He is very, very aggressive on that. And I imagine going to be giving a lot of good intel for his team to make sure they're able to at least hold this for a while. But Penta have been dismantling a lot of defenses very quickly. So I'm not sure Zig's call-ups are going to be really as effective as he would like.
I don't think so either. I think it's going to be staying within the workshop or ventilation and then through there try to get a C4 up top. And this is what he usually does either in Pro League or in BR6. Yeah, and that is so slow. You're relying on the C4 hitting. We've seen Liquid and for other teams even in Latin America missing those shots when they really needed them on maps that are other than the border. Oregon, for example, was one of the maps that a lot of teams just put too much emphasis on C4s to win the game from below.
Even when Pent is playing Monty, C4ing him is hard.
Yeah.
They're too mobile for that kind of play. And so, I mean, I would almost rather see him just playing upstairs and calling out information for his team to rotate to decide whether or not to defend in offices or to focus on the Armory Lockers archives. Because at this point, they just need all the manpower they can. But Kanto says, you're going to have one less man now. Hope you got your ADSs down. Great initial kill once again from him on Sledge.
There you go. Well, that's the early kill. Of course, the Jaeger, not the most important of picks and most important of losses for Team Liquid. But the important thing is that you want to keep Penta away from Zig for as long as possible.
Yeah.
Because if he goes down, that is the backup plan completely down.
Yeah. At that point, you're definitely struggling to just stay in there to be able to actually call out when those smokes and C4 should be coming out. He is going to be playing at least a little bit upstairs. Unfortunately, not completely where the bomb site is. It looks like a very aggressive A take once they start to get that wall open. And there's no one really holding that wall. The Thatcher not even necessary at that point except to get the batteries that are already there. They're not going to attack from below, just going to open. What happened to the battery there?
There was one battery that was set up.
He did lose a thermite charge, though. He's down to one. Maybe a shot from it. Hard to say, but well played. No, Nesk was over there, got the battery on there. Sexy takes down Pengu, though. A good trade back for the Jaeger, taking down the Twitch. Nicely played, and now the mirror window a little safer.
What do we expected usually? Oh, no, he'll get burned by the ADS in the back. That's Bullet at least trying to do something from the grave, but usually it's Fabian that'll be playing the Twitch, and he'll hunt that pulse down for as long as possible.
PSK is
so low on health, but you know what? He'll reply. Goga, where you at? He'll go down to the C4. Team Liquid looking strongly in this one here. Skenta Rocketti trying to go for a peek. I know you can win these 1v1s, but my man, this might not be the position for you to try. Still get shot from below, and you know what? He'll agree at least for this once.
Yeah. He needs the support at this point to help make this push work because they've got too much of a beachhead there. And they're going to go for an attack on offices, and this is where Zig is going to come in to play, assuming he stays alive, but gives away his position by shooting that drone. Now his teammates need to rotate.
At least try to scare Penta off for a second. He can still play with the C4. Jonas will get taken down from the opposite angle of Sexy Cake. Helping out, but what a flick from Kanto. He'll get the shot, Fabian with another one. The LED5's making it work. Our SAS operators will sway away from the C4 as Zig will go in, as well as BSK with barely any health, both of them. I'll take down Penta Sports. Liquid with a second round on the board.
I think a lot of that came down to the Bandit in the mirror. Nesk playing very smartly on the wall, managing to take out one thermite charge, delaying it long enough to get set up for that C4 throw. You saw Kanto just trying to play basketball, getting the grenades through the window. Had that first one worked, that might have worked out because he would have stopped that second C4 throw. But I love the return. You want to throw stuff? Let's throw stuff. Unfortunately for Goga, who is fantastic with the gun when he's not in the middle of trying to put a thermite breach charge up, gets easily picked from that C4. I mean, you saw Kanto with the heads-up play too. He was ready. He shot the C4 as soon as he could. Unfortunately, it was right after it detonated, so close to saving his teammate. Yeah, it's definitely going to be difficult for Penta to pull off the same kind of 5-1 they pulled off last time, now that Liquid's already up to 2. Penta, again, also going with an old-school operator lineup outside of Mira. And Fabian going to be on Rook, something we saw him try some cheeky peeks with previously that definitely did not work out.
Wait. That is a not fully reinforced armor wall.
Nope.
And are they just like waiting until the end, or is it actually part of the plan?
I think it's part of the plan. We had seen them set that up previously to be able to use the side of the wall there, as well as you see Kanto doing for the red hallway. Now, obviously, they're not going to try and rotate it or reinforce it at this point because you'll just get shot doing so.
But as you said, this is a very old school lineup and an old school style of defense. We've seen it a couple times so far in this tournament, because nowadays you basically just hold with a mirror window in the fountain. Now it's just a full open wall where you play from CCTV and look down. You control the hallway, you control fountain at the same time. It has its benefits, but you lose CCTV, you practically have lost most of your map control.
Yeah, it's definitely a difficult thing to do to defend it as well, but it also can be hard to attack because there are a lot of spaces to hide and places to rotate from. But they are going to be taking for an office take so far. They do see the mirror window, though, and they know that they have a little bit of a contest to try. Whoop, the missed shot there. He was getting a little too antsy, but they do need to do something about that window. CCTV is going to be a great counter to pushing in here. Fortunately for Fabian, still alive inside. They reinforced the office's wall, which was the smart play because of the buck here of Zig. Would easily be able to open that. That's typically what the buck was for, is to open up that office's wall. So reinforcing that, maybe that's why they were one short on
the
office's
wall. There we go, that's the grenade. I was waiting for this one here, but
Merry Christmas to Fabian.
Fabian, he's down on the floor. Can they finish him off here? Zig cooking the second grenade. It'll bounce on in, and Fabian, bye-bye, my friend. Arrivederci.
Down the chimney you go. Pengu, though, is waiting for a push here. And Nesk is just droning instead. Drone denied, but Pengu is spotted. Goga is trying to defend the CCTV, as you were mentioning earlier, trying to hold that. But Pengu trades on to Nesk, who does not successfully push up on the AC. And he's still got smoke canisters going ahead here to deny a push onto Archives.
The smoke is coming out as well as all the flashes here from Team Liquid. Bomb will be found, but they need to put that diffuser down, and that's exactly what they're going to try to go for. Goga will go down as the C4 is missed. Bullet gets him. But now PSK and a Bullet low on Hell, Sexy Kick, and Zig on full HP themselves. Jonas turns off his phone for just a second here, as Jonas knows that they need to fight against Vets. No, he's not here. The admin is in here. Sexy Cake will get the kill on Kanta Raketti. Pengu with one more signature spot. Standing up top. They need to come in. No, I won't. What is that? Pengu and Penta will win the round. What is this?
They just
run in, defuse, and just stand on the desk and wait.
That's all you needed was two men. One to hit it, one to watch both the angles. And Pengu is very comfortable standing on top of there, as you saw him doing earlier, like a king of the world. And that should have been a Liquid win, as they were tearing apart the defense. But nope, Pengu just holding it off as long as possible, using the smoke canisters, delaying as much as possible. And Bullet definitely gave it a valiant effort, but unfortunately, they could not guard the defuse plant because they pushed it in a position they couldn't defend it from two different angles at once.
The problem is, the rest of the Team Liquid, the two players that were left at the end, were not anywhere near the site to help.
Nope.
They could not hear the diffuser. They were not set up to protect from Pengu's peaks.
It's because it was a little bit of a frantic plan. Yeah. They weren't ready set up for the post plant. And that's the thing, is that's why you want to have so much time left at the end. If you can start to get set up for the plant with a minute left, you can actually get set up for the plant, as opposed to planting and struggling to frag out at the end to keep that plant down. Sexy, though, with six kills, I mean, I got to give him a lot of credit. I know we keep joking about this, but him playing without Blitz and fragging out that well, it's been impressive, because we saw so much of him using that earlier, and it being such a linchpin, it started to make you think maybe he's too one-dimensional. Absolutely not. He's been playing fantastic, especially on this map.
I remember around exactly a year ago, I was talking to our Brazilian casters, Meligeni and Betaya, and I asked them, guys, what do you think about Sexy Case? Because we've been seeing him like playing around in teams, and he's pretty darn good. And in their mind, he's basically the best player that any team would like to have on their team. And you know what? We've seen him jumping around between teams until we got to meet him in Brazil in the season finals. And there, he's like, you know what? I'm going big.
Yeah,
now we're
going
to
get
to the big league. And it's working out definitely fine for Team Liquid, that's for sure. Sexy Cake, one of the best players that you'd ever want to have on your squad.
Now, because Liquid won this top floor, they have to go down to Vents. However, this attack is going to be fairly similar. You've got Goga set up with Thermite, could be used to help breach this, or he could be more focused on blowing wall downstairs, depending how they need to use him. But a little bit of greedy push there. Nesk punishes and gets a two-piece for it. Unfortunate, they were not clearing that as well as they should, and he actually gets back before Pengu peaks. Just bad communication and teamwork there in punishing Nesk. He's getting away with it. Half his health for a 2K like that. It's not looking good for Penta, who just... This has not been their map today.
No, nope, not at all. At least now, two grenades have been removed from play. The sports, Nesk, as you said, only took a half damage, but you know that's no problem. Already just put the frags on the board. Flashes will get thrown in here by Pengu. Nobody is in those eastern stairs. We'll open up the wall. There we go, finally. That is the reinforced doorway. Fabian trying to sneak in with his Twitch drone. They know that they have to deal with Ziggs near a window. Goga is going to be the one to come in and lose out his drone. You want to try to bait out maybe your own drones if you can sneak in that Twitch drone right behind. There's basically none for Fabian to use except for the one that's already been deployed. And Pengu will get the kill here. Fragging on Sexy Cake. He'll take down the Valkyrie. Zig taking quite a bit of damage as well from the Ashes. Nesk super close up. Fabian pulls back at the last second here.
Smart play. He senses someone there. He's not overextending himself, letting Pengu soften him up and then playing perfectly into it. This is really starting to work out for them. And there goes the camera, because 3v3 with all the intel they need.
Even though they have the camera there, Zig still pushed out. And that's one thing I don't understand, because they had the info on Fabian before they pushed. But still have Nesk downstairs. Pengu rotating in. There's one player in bathroom. 32 seconds left on the clock. They'll open up one side wall here as Goga will try to fight against the bathroom with PSK. Low on health, he'll get the headshot though, that's all you need. Fabian trying to find it, but Nest will get another one here, and Bullet with the last one, Liquid up 3-1.
Look at that, Sexy Kick having so much fun now, he's already got one leg up on his chair, excited and ready to do this. They are definitely in this still. I mean, despite the scoreline you saw on map one, we could see the reverse of that scoreline on map two, which again is the flipped map picks. Despite picking Bank, obviously Penta very comfortable on that as we knew, but we didn't expect it to be such a shutdown. And again, we didn't expect Border to be shut down on Penta earlier from Rogue, and it's starting to look like the same thing. This is a map that used to be so well known as being Penta's map. Starting to really question that after today.
Oof. Bullet jumping down, landing the final shot.
Nicely done. Look at that Sexy Cake, as well as Pengu. Pengu definitely did a lot of work last round trying to set Fabian up, trying to help him out, help Goga out as well. Fabian doing some good work also. Just unfortunately losing too many early. That play by Nesk in CCTV, I would say, absolutely cost Penta that round. They had so much maneuverability in play towards the end, but without the manpower, there was not really much of an execute they could pull. And now Penta are going to try that same defense down in vents yet again. Can they hold it off this time against Liquid? Sexy Kick back on that line that was so effective last time.
5 seconds left. Attackers have located a bomb.
Reinforcement here in the fountain. Counter Rocketti setting up his mirror window. And I wonder who's going to stay there. Maybe it's going to be the Bandit of Yunus. Because, we never see him playing in Fountain. That's for sure, right?
No, right now, I think he's still on Armory Locker's wall, so.
He'll be there eventually.
Yeah, he's got things to do, places to be. But they are going to focus a little bit on downstairs first. They want to see what they're going to have to deal with. And
wait.
Looks like a complete downstairs push here for Bathroom.
Team Liquid are going to get a lot more aggressive than expected here.
Wow.
Spot the leg of the smoke.
There we go.
Get him. Yes, Nesk will take him out. Liquid are running away with this here. As now all the hatches are going to get open. Yonas and Kanto, though, getting a kill each as they're using the top of the surface to their advantage. Finally, Nesk will land the headshot on Kanto as he's very low on health. 3v2, and the Diffuser has not been set just yet. Nesk will not see the drop. Does he see the player that moved away? Where are you going, Pengu? Yunus playing from the top side. His Bullet taking down Pengu all on Yunus, and this is working. The rush play from Liquid has been perfected. And Penta did not expect this one here as the Diffuser is down, and Bullet will take down Yunus. What a fantastic bit of execution from
that
Team Liquid.
Such a beautiful attack execution. They did the droning, they looked into how the defense was set up and said, you know what, this is weak. They're depending too much on Castle to slow us down. They think we're gonna fight that top four. We don't wanna deal with Judas up there guarding that wall. You know what?
I wonder who this crowd is cheering for.
Are we gonna see this 5-1? Yeah, I think Liquid have gotten a few fans out there. I'm sure Fabian has made sure of that.
No, I think people dislike Fabian.
No, I mean, I'm saying, you know, just because he's said so many nice things about all the other teams. That's true.
Yeah, very, very good point.
But Armory Lockers smirk. Again for this defense. Yeah.
That smirk.
He was born smirking.
I'll have to get pictures of him when he was a baby, that's for sure. But let's get this one here on the road. See Tom Lee, a.k.a. Shass, who has called out the tactical pause for Penta Sports, the one that they get for this map, as they now converse and talk and see what they can change and what they have done wrong. 4-1, it wasn't as fast as the call from Liquid was on map one, being on the fourth, right before the fourth round,
yeah,
when they were down 3-0.
Well, Penta doesn't feel like they need it, generally. They're like, okay, it's fine, we can come back, because they are a good comeback team without needing to do a tactical pause. But yeah, this is a good time on this map.
Yeah, very much so. Well, see Kanto Rocketti and the team conversing, seeing got to do, and on the other side, on the blue camp, everybody's happy, everybody's cheerful, and you know what? With an extra leg up,
absolutely.
There you go.
Yeah, fantastic play from Liquid, especially that last round. That was just, you see it, you take it, you win. There's that little horse Zig likes to bring with him.
Yeah. Well, there is the joke, you know, Mirata Cavalla. That's the you know,
his little horsey.
That's his little horsey. He brought it.
He rode that right on in.
Mosey on down a border then. We'll see how this one pans out as Liquid will be setting up on the defense, and Pengu is bringing the Zofia.
That's maybe the change they needed. They didn't have a lot of soft reachers before, other than occasionally when Pengu brought Ashe. He's changing up Dash for the Zofia. Makes a lot of sense. But will it make a lot of deaths here as they're going to try and get underway into what could be the last round on Border? However, the last map is going to be Consulate, and that's been an interesting one for these teams. That has been one that has been, I'd say, good for both regions. So that could be a great decider. Although we've seen Penta, you know, when they lose map number two, sometimes we'll just drop the hammer on map number three, and it'll be a short, short round.
We'll see if Kanto can drop the hammer on anybody in this round, because Penta definitely do need it.
Well, if anyone's going to, yeah, it'd be Kanto with that sledge.
And there you go. We'll open up both of the doorways here to the Valkyrie inside of Zig, who's playing in what is usually the Yuna spot. And this is the thing. Both players are ones that know exactly how to counter it because they play it themselves.
Absolutely. They've got to worry about this hallway. Peeking, there we go. Make sure to safely check that it does not have a window on it, which it does not. Now, they have taken control of CCTV without getting picked off by Nesk this time, and that is a good start for that. But they seem to be rotating around, trying to figure out where to go. You see Kanto doubling back, trying to figure out what the play is at this point, because Goga has struggled to open that wall every time, and this is where they have the problem. Kanto tried to help with the last time, but was unable to do so. There we saw a Zofia from below. Pengu opened it up so Fabi could take out the batteries. That's what needed to happen.
Pengu Fantastic. Will go down. They open it perfectly, as you mentioned, and that's why you bring the Zofia as well.
Yeah, the Zofia Twitch combo, the safest way to open that. And when Gogo was struggling, that's the change they needed. Fantastic changeup. I'm not sure if that was Fabian or Shasta's call, but Pengu switching up there. Smart play. Now they've got the wall open. Now it is on.
Hallway being completely cornered here by Penta. Still spot the cameras being set up or that have been set up in the past by Zig. Pengu rotating around to the fence, which is basically the spot that he always
Yeah, he can hit some good stuns from here. He has one left he can use. It's also a good angle.
Especially Penta pushing from the other side mostly.
Yeah.
So this way he can concuss his opponent to go in, but PSK is ready. He takes a lot of damage. Still hits the headshot. And you know what? That is what matters. Kanto Rakete will have to rush on in here. Pengu will get one now. The Mira will go down, but Zig, just one more. Can they go for the plant? That's exactly what they're going to try to do. It's either rotation from the stairs and from CCTV. Zig now down as Pengu's holding that one doorway. Now they know the second one, and Kanto Rakete nails the headshot. Penta are trying to bring it back. Well, now the second round on the board.
Kanto and Pengu definitely delivered that round. That was exactly what they needed to do. It got a little sloppy with Fabian's Russian, but then you saw the exact same thing from Kanto with a beautiful execute on it. I don't think he was set up, poor PSK, for two rushes to his face. He got at least some electricity damage out of both of those, but not a whole lot, and a great play. Good flank control there by Pengu as well, trying to help out. And then, of course, Kanto with the heads-up play, taking advantage of the fact that he saw the window in the small office to know exactly the rotate was either going to come around through metal, or he was just going to have to watch CCTV. And he was right on the corner of both angles, playing it smartly, using those holes in the wall they had set up in CCTV to his advantage.
All right, well, I've heard this crowd cheering for Liquid. Well, I don't know if you want to see a third map in this one, because right now it's looking very much like a potential third one. See if we can cheer for Liquid to maybe see map three in this series. Of course, one more round separates Liquid from that oh-so-dear third map. Maybe they can take it back and win it for the first time for Latin America.
Now they are setting up this time with the double reinforcements on the armory wall. They're not going to go with the half reinforcement we had seen previously. I think a big part of that was making sure they had the extra reinforcements for the office side. In this case, it does help because you have Zig bringing that buck yet again. So I imagine Zig bringing that is either going to be there to take out the batteries or to rotate around to the office. But we did see him focusing towards the office side last time before realizing it was a no-go with reinforcements. And he heard a little bit of damage go out there from someone, it sounded like. No one looks damaged just yet. Sexy back online, which has been very effective. This could be the shutdown round. Fabian, though, bringing out something a little bit different with a mute for the first time. We'll see if that shuts down anything here, as it's not like you're going to really stop a whole lot of droning on this, because they are going to be focused on entering the map.
There you go. Claymore's going to get set up, and the camera on the stairs will get shut down. That's pretty much your standard checklist as your support operator here.
What a great play.
What a great
That play. Camera managed.
And the drone goes down! That's a very impressive play.
So, they are using those drones, though. You're not seeing them really get stopped too much by the mute. So the mute not being critical here. They do have a mute and a bandit. That means there will be a little bit of denial that denies them the ability to try and bring any drones in through that doorway to try and spot whether or not Junus is playing on that wall, but you gotta guess he is.
Nesk, now will he charge in? We've seen this before where the droning has been so important, so essential for Liquid, because with that, you can guarantee that your Ash will just keep running through and charging into everybody. But with two players of Penta looking down here, there's almost no chance of you making it through no matter what. You can't put a shield on top of your head and run with it.
You know what, though? The way he Ashed the floor there and then left it, pretty much left Junus to do it again. Now, they did drone to find out he's doing it, but I don't think Nesk is going to be able to do anything to stop him because he's gone back upstairs. So that didn't necessarily accomplish a ton because he's still got batteries to place, still going to trick this. They don't have a Thatcher to stop it, so I don't know how effective that was. It might have been better to have Zig down there, but at least Lion doing some work.
A little spot counter Rocketti, but here, Jonas trying to contest against the machine. There we go, finally. No, will not be able to get
what?
The kill on the S-Miller. What a form counter Rocketti will fall down, though. Being very greedy in here, but PSK opening up the wall.
But the kill he chased, Nesk.
That's the important one. That's the Ash that wanted to run in, and I don't see any barbed wire on the inside. It would have been a lot easier to run in for Nesk. We've seen him do that against Millennium in our previous matchup. Logic Bomb will be deployed, and as well as the Lion here, the E1D. And I'll spot the Mute, and Fabian will go down. Pengu with one more on to Zig, though, to refrag. 3v3. The advantage here for Penta's side with 31 seconds left on the clock. Sexy Cake does not have any E1Ds to play with. All the Texan Dynamite for a Thermite here has been removed. And well, there are no Logic Bombs to play with. You're going to have to run in guns blazing and hope for the best. And you know what? Liquid definitely have done this before. See if they have enough time for it, but 10 seconds on the clock. C4 will get thrown in.
Boom!
Will not hit. There we go. It hits one in the back. Thermite as well taken down by Jonas as Bullet would take it, but Pengu grabs the kill on Bullet. And now Penta are starting to bring this one back. 4-3 still up for Liquid. They are on map point, but Penta Sports are one round away from taking it into overtime.
You know, you may call Kanto's push greedy, but what he did was pushed out on the one person who's going to be the counter to Junus. By doing that, traded his life for it, and saved Junus for later. Junus absolutely critical on holding that half wall there that C4 perfectly timed. Not to mention, knowing he was there, they could not push safely. They didn't have any more EE1Ds. And then Pengu, of course, hey, I've got you, bud, with the flank. Boom. Easy round for them at that point. Just because of the lack of time and lack of ability to execute with the manpower, fantastic, and worked out in their favor. Now, they're bringing again the Zofia and the Twitch, but this time they're going to be attacking Vents, so we'll see how that works out in their favor. I don't imagine we're going to see a rush like we saw from Liquid onto the bottom, but you never know. If they read into it, they could go for it.
Are they crazy enough to do that? I don't think Penta is as efficient as Liquid is when it comes to just being, you know, cojones to the wall.
They have the operators to pull it off, though. So it could happen. Pengu already up to 10, getting a little jealous of Kanto.
Yeah, he's giving him a run for his money, that's for sure.
Well, either way though, being down a point and still having that many kills, you see the work coming out from those two, especially the teamwork and good coverage. Now if the rest of them could step it up, we could see a pretty easy potential overtime here.
And we'll see how Liquid sets up for this one here. It's very similar to what we see with Penta when they're defending workshop and ventilation. They're going to be setting up upstairs. Hold the armory wall will get reinforced and bandit wired, as well as the mirror window. We'll have basically all the holes opened up. The hatch is opened up as well to rotate down. Right now, very standard play from Liquid. There's nothing out of the ordinary, nothing too special. It's just always the question with Liquid, really. Do they get aggressive or do they play reactive or passive?
Well, thankfully, Goga's making sure that CCTV is clear so they can get in and get that control. Because then they go for the Pengu and Fabian open of the battery wall. And not a lot Nesk can do about it, necessarily, because it's such a safe play, unless he can hit the shock drone before it can take out his batteries.
Jonas just holding on to the east stairs. You see Fabian trying to mosey on in here with his Twitch drone. Oh, the Jaeger will spot it, and that is a loss here.
He needs another one to be able to take out the batteries of Nesk if he can, although maybe they're not too concerned about that.
Yeah, they do have Pengu and the Zofia. We've seen it before. But unfortunately, this is not like what you can do if you're attacking Armory because, well, the sites are downstairs.
Yeah, absolutely. You still need to get in and take top floor control. However, they decided offices is the way to go. And June is going to be helping out Kanto here on the push, on the pinch. Try and clear Fountain. Once they do so, then they can start put a lot more pressure on Archives and push their way through, force people to drop Hatch. But Kanto forces them to drop to their death instead.
Well, and we'll get shot down by Kanto Riketti. Jonas up top. Maybe somebody will peek from that infamous Pengu angle that we've seen before. Grenade's going to get shot in from Kanto. As he does not hit really anybody here, Pengu taking just a bit of damage as Fabian is held up in the main hallway. He's going to be looking around, waiting, maybe protecting the flank, because you know there's a few spots where they'll get pushed in. The Claymore has not been set up for just in case, but it's possibly because Fabian wants to move in from here. Pengu is still up on the ventilation, a standard spot. Right now, it's just Penta crawling their way in.
What's interesting is Liquid are not playing with a castle on this. They're just using wooden barricades, which are not going to do a whole lot for you here.
And of course, with the with Zofia that's being brought for Penta, it definitely makes those barricades a lot less powerful.
Yeah, absolutely.
But still, castle has been such a huge pick in this season. See how flexible he is, but we'll see how Penta flexible they are with 35 seconds left on the clock. And you know they might have a man up, but when you're pushing a site as turtle as this one here on the workshop. Gotta be very careful. Kanto Riketti with the SMG 11 in hand. The smoke will get popped in here as Kanto will lose out the fight against PSK in the bathroom. And Liquid, remember, they only need one round. A lot of damage done to Zig and PSK, but Bolt will go down to Jonas. Jonas with one more on PSK. Pulling up the pistol. That's Fabian to get one more. Nesk will have to clean this one up here. Just to clutch it with 5 seconds left on the clock. We know he's coming from the bathroom. Jonas trying to contest with the pistol, and he'll nail the headshot here. Nesk, but Fabian's ready, and Nesk will go down. Ladies and gentlemen, Penta Sports clawed back into overtime.
Overtime, here we go. Penta, despite getting stomped on this map with a three-round comeback.
There's a reason why even Zig called them the best team in the world. This is why. It's never over until it says winner.
Yeah, well, ventilation again from Liquid. Because they're starting on defense, we're going to see the same basic defense. Nope, they're switching around here. Operator roulette as they try and decide how they want to play it. Sexy's going to be on Echo. So this is going to be a different strategy than what we just saw. Still not going to play the castle, deciding that is not the most important part. But it worked fairly well for the defense. Did they switch to upstairs? No, that's still... Yeah, they switched to upstairs at the last second. Okay, they're going to be playing Armory. That's why the roulette. But Echo upstairs...
And Sexy
choice.
Yeah, playing that. Not Zig, which is what we usually see, especially when we saw that on Bank playing.
Well, when you know Sexy's been taking over Zig roles, he's been doing them pretty well. So, surprisingly, not going to see Zig on Pulse either, but he is the information gatherer, so he's going to be throwing those cameras instead. Going to see a pretty typical setup from Penta, although in this case, they're going to have Kanto on Ash as well as Pengu on Zofia. So not going to be bringing Sledge from Kanto, which has been working pretty well, I would say. So interesting changeup. Not sure if they knew which bomb site they were going to be attacking. However, this has been the primary. This is, you know what? We can't defend walls both we like, so forget Bandit. Let's just shoot them when they get near.
That's an oldie but goldie.
Yeah, and they haven't fully reinforced the back armory either. So
they
might be giving it up here to
Penta,
that armory.
Penta have two offices. Soft destructors.
Yeah, that office wall is going to get open right up if they don't reinforce it. I mean, Zig could try if he's got one left, but that's going to be short-lived, and offices is going to be where they're going to attack here. Sexy not going to be doing a whole lot from this side.
And Jonas just taking down the camera. Fabian now pulling finally down from the spot. We've seen him. Exactly 1 year ago, nailing two kills in the end. I believe that was Gamescom. I will correct myself there. But the Valkyrie camera will get taken out. The Thermite will open up the reinforced wall in here. Now Penta will have a secondary entrance. Zig somehow nails one, nails two!
Whoa.
And Zig able to get the 2K here with the headshots on Goga and Jonas. The Hard Destructor has just been taken down. Jonas down on the floor. And Pengu now eliminated by Nets. This is looking very much like a Liquid round. Fabian and Kanto Riketti, the last two players alive.
You know, leaving that softball just really baited him into Zig on that jump out, and they absolutely use it to their advantage. And Pengu's been playing maybe that AC unit a little too much, getting a little too predictable. So they definitely baited him into some great plays here by Liquid, showing they can defend this pretty well this time around with this interesting lineup.
You see the drone from Fabian coming in. Not able to really pick anything off of that. There's no utility anywhere around us. Fabian will go up, just climb up on the wall on the north side. As he will go to the same spot that we saw Pengu playing from before.
Attackers have located a bomb.
Possibly the case here.
A lot of time left, though, for Penta. I mean, I guess that happens when you lose three people that early on.
Right. Well, it seems like Archive will be the position to go for. Fabian will take just a bit of damage on the crossover. That is what you trade for such a great spot. Scanta Ricchetti moving very closely here. He knows that there's one more angle that he has to check. And there we go. He'll down the smoke. Nesk will be down on the floor. The Jaeger will take down Scanta Ricchetti. But Fabian will get one. 60 cake, though, will respawn from distance, from range. The MP5 will get the headshot. PSK as well, helping him out. Look at that close range running off.
That's the unfortunate part about not having any pressure on the other side. Losing Freeman early really hurt them. They couldn't put any cross pressure because Pengu had died on the AC unit. They didn't have anyone to rotate around to be able to put pressure on Sexy Cake. And he used that ACOG to his advantage to play from the side of the site they weren't even bothering with. And looks like Liquid want to close this map out as Sexy is now on Blitz.
Yep, very much so. That is the perfect position for them to play in when it is the last round. You've already put Penta on edge. You know what? Go for the one thing that they might not be thinking about because you haven't played it this entire series.
No, almost baiting them into being comfortable without having to fight it. You see Nesk and Sexy Cake doing some work. Bullet as well has really stepped up this map, and the other two as well with six. The whole team doing some good work. Unfortunately, Goga, despite his fantastic performances earlier, been struggling a bit on this map.
Yep, very much the case. At least they'll set up here. They're even bringing a shield to play with inside. They've been using that a couple times. It protects them a bit from the grenades. They're going to get thrown in to the fountain, or in the case of, you know, the back wall being thermite.
Yeah, we have seen the thermite attempts as well to try and help pressure fountains, but that was on the other team at the time.
So attackers recover the diffuser.
Fabian could be on the roam here. Looks like downstairs. I'm not sure how effective they'll be. Pengu actually the one taking up the mute this time. Can't do back on that Mira. Goga and Junas playing pretty much what they always play for the most part because they play it well. So will they be able to stop the Blitz train? That's the real question of this, because if they can, this could fall apart for Liquid and we could see it go to a 6-5. If not, we move on to Consulate.
So this is the question, where do Liquid go to? Will they push from the Armory side or will they push from Archives? Both positions are definitely doable here for our Blitz, but both positions require control of the bottom floor. If not, gotta be afraid of basically any C4 that can get thrown out, either from Fabian or Pengu.
And that's where Fabian's gonna come in, because not only is he the one downstairs, but of course he's got that C4. Maybe not a pulse, but he's still got three eyeballs around the map to help him find where he needs to hit that C4.
Well, four C4s being brought here for Penta. That's a lot.
Yeah,
explosive power.
Especially for Sexy Cake, that's what he's going to have to worry about, is that all those C4s coming flying at him. But with the speed that, and aggression that Blitz has now, a lot of times you just push into the C4 thrower, kill him before he could detonate it, or just take a little bit of damage from behind.
Well, Michael Bay will be proud, that's for sure. Zig opening up here the wall that was not reinforced by Penta. Fabian still playing downstairs. The beepers as Goga is set up. He does have an ADS to protect him here, as well as deployable shields. So the grenades, it won't be as tough. Nesk yet again still running that Penta Charm on his R4C.
Nice of him.
Is it respect? Is it, you know, a sign of we're going to take your spot? Well, we'll just have to see. Maybe this round will be the one that propels Liquid into a possible comeback for a victory for the first time in the history of Latin America in Rainbow Six Pro League.
It definitely could happen here. Liquid have been showing up big time on this map. Penta have been showing they don't really care about those initial rounds. Phone call, though, going to delay Goga a little bit in the smoke as well. As PSK1 takes down Kanto, that is a big hit for Penta.
The ADS will get taken down. It's now Goga still playing with the back grenade. Will get lobbed in on Jonas. This dropped on the floor. You see three players in the back, but Goga will finally land the first kill of his in this matchup. That's one now down. Zig on the floor. We'll try to thermite the wall, and Jonas, will he die? No, he will survive as Nesk gets one. Goga still set up on the side as Pengu will get one on PSK. 3v3, and now the fencer spotted. Pengu will try to push in. He's solo and held down 50%. And that's Blitz. Oh, here we go. Go, one. Pengu with another. One more still alive, and it's all on to Nesk. We've seen him before clutching this one out. Two alive, Goga and Pengu. 8 seconds on the clock. They reverse their positions. They're not going to peek him here. Nest, you'll have to go for the kills. Pengu runs out of ammo, and there's no more time remaining as Pengu gets the last shot. Ladies and gentlemen, 5-5 in overtime. Penta have brought it back.
They brought it hard. I would say almost four rounds in a row. That is how you do it for Penta. As I said, early map, early rounds, they don't care. They don't get fazed by it. That's why they're the top team in the world.
How do you stop these people? How do you stop this team?
I know, you kill Penta with the beginning too, and it's still like, no, there's Pengu still. You forgot about Pengu. I love that Judas didn't even die to the wall. He dropped down the hatch and only died after the round end.
He's just chilling on the floor.
You can't even kill him when they're down. So 5-5 scoreline, and we're going to see Glass brought out by Junas. Something I mentioned earlier that he plays, but we just haven't seen a whole lot of this weekend. Not always been the most effective, but this is the round that doesn't matter as much to Penta as it does to Liquid right now, because this, if Liquid lose this,
it's all
out. Yeah, if Penta loses, I don't think Fabian will even lose his smirk for a second.
That'll be a difficult one, trying to shake that one off. But we've seen that even in the interview, as Matt was talking to Fabian, was saying, you know what? We're reset after every single map, completely. And that's why. This is what they're playing for. They're playing for these trophies, but that's not the only thing you take home with. You take a decent chunk of cash. Winning team with over $75,000.
Hopefully, a nice chunk of change.
Hopefully, they don't spend them all in one place, especially not here in Atlantic City. Well, but
imagine Fabian's got his shoes off right now, getting ready for that interview. We have Kanto back on Sledge. Fabian going to be on the line this time. Gogut, well, why would you put him on anything else going to be on Thermite? But interestingly, Pengu on Thatcher is an interesting choice. So hopefully he can help Junas get set up for those Glass picks. That is, it's going to be an interesting one on this particular bomb site where that Glass is going to be useful, as there are not a ton of angles to work. I mean, maybe he could be working from the bathroom if they can get over there and go for a push on that. There are some ways to help on the attack on the top floor, of course, because you still need to take that unless you're Liquid and just say, nah, it's fine, we gotta just rush the bathroom. Pengu, wow, definitely showing up for his team this round, this map. Fantastic plays by him, especially that last round, saving it for the team and giving them one last chance to close this out in two maps for a potential 2-0. Kanto already in. Looking to check the metal detector. They are trying to clear this bottom floor very quickly here. And that's going to put a lot of pressure, because if the rest of the team takes the top floor, that's going to force people to drop. But you see, Judas also droning the bottom floor. Could be a very bottom-heavy attack here.
Kanto is hungry for another title. We'll remind you, he played under Ence and technically still does, has been loaned by our Finnish organization to Penta.
That's true. The last season was won by him. So
we might have a repeat champion, technically.
That's smart of him to go to the team that's going to be here.
Very much so. Well, they're very close here, Penta Sports. They still need one more round, and Liquid need this one round to go into the third map. Penta been able to bring it back, and you see Penta already at the 2-minute mark. They're set up outside of the site, where we'll start to break things. Goga setting up his exothermic charge. Jonas opening up the doorway in the bathroom. You see the smoke is set up in the back with his SMG-11, that is PSK, that has been such a rock, standing in the back.
They have one man unaccounted for upstairs as well. Fabian on that lion could be the man who punishes them from behind as they start to drop hatches. This is a smart play. They need to play the right timing, though, and some great shots on Bullet going to take him to about half health.
Oh, Pengu just bringing the breach charge there. He'll open up the side of the wall, just giving them a bit of an extra angle to play with, as, well, remind you, Goga has opened the reinforced wall right in front of them, right to the side of the bathroom leading to workshop. Now Fabian will run on into the hall. He'll pop his E1D. As you see here, the Jaeger's
spotted,
and the bullet will go down. And that's the first kill. Goga going in for the quick plant on the Thermite. Yunus holding off for any of the rotations. And will this go down? Yes, it will. Sexy Cake, though, will drop one. Two kills, though. A flurry for Liquid as Goga gets one. Zik with one more. They're on fire. Pengu, last man alive here. He's got a clutches. He's done it before. He's waiting. He spots the one player. Zig is somehow still alive, but he gets shot from the side. Ladies and gentlemen, Team Liquid, they survive. And we'll see a third map. The revenge from last year. Liquid almost going down. They bring it back in. The energy on this team is absolutely insane. And we'll see a third one, Devin. It is not over until Maestro sinks.
Liquid like a coiled snake that round. Everything in Penta's favor. Even Fabian getting an easy kill upstairs. What are the odds of Liquid turning that around despite the strong start? Fantastic play from everyone at Liquid, showing they have the potential to take a peg out of the top team in the world and maybe a seat on their throne.
That makes me sad that I forgot my Brazilian flag in Katowice, but...
You without a Brazilian flag? It must be the Maestro thing just throwing you off.
Very much so. But let's see how this one pans out here, because we still have one more map to go through. But before we do that, we have to analyze things and see how we got all the way to here. So, standing by, it's my wonderful dance partner, Matt Andrews, on the desk with Fox and Zeronic.
2-3-4, 2-3-4. Yes, indeed. Thank you, Milos and Emzo in a grand final at last. I'm pleased to see them getting the chance to cast this one. Oh, and it is one. It is a grand final, is it not? And we were chatting just now about what Zeronic wants to say, how he wants to describe this thing to you, but the words aren't allowed. It's that simple, isn't it, Zeronic?
Yep. So I'm just going to say it's really good.
It is really good, isn't it?
It's fun.
But it is. But it is so, again, I know we've had these things this weekend, to here we are again. Oh, this is going very one-sided. This is going to be over really soon. Let's all get ready to wrap this thing up. Well, if they win, they win. I'm a bit disappointed how it's happened. No, we're not done yet. No, we'll have some more.
It's just been a full event of upsets. Like,
yeah,
it keeps going super favorable in one team's direction, and then next map, the other team goes, we don't want to lose yet.
No, we're not done yet, and nor should they be. So 5-1 for Penta on the opening map, and then we get some really big overtime as Liquid go, well, we want to have fun.
Yeah, that first
map. But we would also like to hold those trophies.
Yeah, but on that first map, Team Kanto played really well.
Yeah, yeah, Kanto Sports.
Yeah, and then the second map, it was just kind of... His team started to play, so it threw them off, and that's why I think Liquid, their fun overlap.
So you're saying Kanto Sports won the first map, and
yeah,
the rest of Kanto's team,
well, of course, like,
upset it on the second?
Every map, of course, a team has a play in it, but on Bank, when he was playing Ashdock, the fact that he was able to get the first pick in the first couple of seconds or a minute is just ridiculous how he's able to get it, and he still didn't just get one kill. He racked them up. He had the most amount of kills in that series, so...
To kind of compare how well he played, it took Pengu 10 rounds to get 13 kills.
Yeah.
It took Kanto 4.
Yeah, 13.
He was 10-0 in the four first rounds on Bank.
So, this is unusual for Siege, let's be honest, because we know what a tactical game this is, and we've never put KDs as like an important thing. I mentioned that yesterday during the quarterfinals. We have one or two players who have very impressive ones from their season, and I wanted to highlight they can get that done. But that's not what Siege is entirely about. That's not something we've ever given
as
focused to compared to other games, unless you just keep piling the other team up.
Yeah,
as the game evolves, it's always going to be more of a team meta that's adapting. But the team just told Kanto to do what he does best, and he just killed everyone. He picked the dog, got those peaks. Ash, super fast, good gun, ran in, got the kills. And at that point, it was like, where was Nesk? He was just getting shot first.
So what is going on with Nesk? Because we did mention earlier, Kanto, Nesk, like, if we're going to talk about fragging, and that seems to be the final that we've been given, where's Nesk's count? Why isn't that rising like Kanto's is?
I think for the first time in a long time, Penta's playing really aggressive. I don't think that fits well into how Nesk plays. When we saw them, when we saw him get his good frags, it's been against teams that had, you know, solid holes. They were sticking to what they were doing. We had a little bit of the same on border in the start. Penta was sat down and Liquid started just, you know, going five guys from the same door. And that works for them when they're the aggressor. But it seems a little bit like Nesk struggles when the other team is doing the same.
Yeah, Penta is an amazing team at shutting down entry fraggers. We see it time and time again, last Invitational against NVK on EG. He wasn't able to fully perform because they are so good at shutting down the entry. They know Nesk is a fast player. So even in that first round, we saw Kanto get a first pick in the first 20-30 seconds off of Nesk. So they know he's going to be going for the aggressive plays. He's going to be in these open situations, and they just isolate him, and Kanto does the work.
Plus, the spawn peek Kanto did with Doc, there's more to it than that, right? Because you spawn peek to start with, and that scares the team for the rest of the game. Because now you have to remember that they got the guts to actually go for that spawn peek.
Yeah, you very all the confident windows. Statement.
Yep.
I like it, honestly. I like how this final is going. We wouldn't dare try and predict who's going to win, but here in Atlantic City, I know we're getting great support for both teams. Who wants Liquid to take it? And who thinks the trophy shelf with a lot on it needs to be made some more room for Penta Sports to get another one? Yeah, you hear how it's going here. People are interested in either of these teams winning, but maybe preferring a new champion. Emzo and Milos, take us there. Let's find out. It's Liquid against Penta Sports for the Season 7 Championship, and there is one more map to go.
And 4, 5, 6, we're back in this one here. Thank you very much, Matt. We're bringing it back. Let's see what happens in this one. Devin, so calm. Everybody's here. Everybody's relaxed, because everybody's ready for this next one. One more map separates us. We actually got all the way through. I was so scared that it would just end in a 2-0.
It honestly should have, with how Penta played that round. Whatever Liquid did right at the end there, we couldn't even see half of it because it was such a fast execute on the retake. Just slaughtered everyone. You saw how fast they just waltzed into sight. It wasn't as fast to say when Liquid did it, but it was just as easy. In fact, maybe too easy. Maybe it seemed like, Liquid were playing from the outside.
That's the thing. But you know what, ladies and gentlemen, you hear that exciting music in the back, you know what time it is?
Consulate time!
It is time for Consulate. Put your hands together for the final map! Going the distance here, Penta Sports versus Team Liquid! Let's go, and let's see if we're gonna crown a new champion, or it'll be yet again, Penta Sports taking it all home. This is revenge, maybe, for North America. We have a North American crowd. Penta Sports took down EG. They took down Rogue.
Well, Brazil's still part of the Americas.
Well, technically so. So there you go. You hear the crowd. They're very much
some support for the Americas.
Yeah, some support for the Americas. That is for sure. At this point, everybody here has adopted Brazil as part of the continent and as the country itself. As you know what, the U.S. melting pot. But this is what they're playing for and a ton of cash as well. Let's see how this one pans out. One of Penta's best map here, but we'll remind you that we said that about Border, and look at how that turned out.
I tried not to say that after the Rogue match. Learned my lesson there. Unfortunate for Penta, but they did bring it back to a very, very close 6-5, so it was far from their worst map, I would say. They just got off to a little bit of a slow start. We'll see how they start here on console office, though. Up top floor, Fabian on that pulse. I imagine going to be roaming, could be all the way down in the archives as he heads down the stairs. That is pretty much where you're almost always going to be playing the pulse, so no surprises here.
We'll remind you that Penta lost this same map during the season to Millennium, and of course, if you weren't watching, guess who Team Liquid just beat in the semifinals before this? That was Team Millennium. There we go. Put one and one together.
But as Penta said, they also had a tendency this season to drop a map. They just did, so guess what that means for this map. Penta not looking to drop it anytime soon. However, they are going to be up against what has definitely proven to be the toughest team so far this weekend.
Well, Claymore is going to get set up here by Nesk on the Ying. We've seen him doing so much damage in pretty much every single operator he gets to play.
Absolutely.
Liquid not bringing Sexy Cake on the Blitzer. Ooh, to be honest, Nesk. He's gonna come on down and get that block back in his hand.
Not a big loss, but moments like that really tilt you.
And again.
Well.
Yep, it happens to pros. Yeah, I know. You try to knife that barbed wire, you try to throw in that drone.
You try to sledge that window.
Yeah, you're not the only one that happens to, even to the best players in the world.
Jaeger
not alone.
Spotted there. Goga trying to defend himself from grenades with that ADS, but the ADS and him both spotted. Around the corner, they did reinforce the wall, and there's no Havana, so that will keep him alive for the moment, but it will also keep him pinned down, as Zig gonna completely take advantage of it. He does need to do something to burn the ADS first, and you see the ADS getting burned, they're gonna call that out. Now it's time for Zig's grenade to come rain death, and he tries to put down one last ADS. Too little too late, Goga. You gotta put it down earlier. Unfortunate and really well played.
How was there not an ADS preset there?
There was. It was just burned, and he went to put the second one down. He saw his silhouette sticking it on the ground. Unfortunately, the grenade was a little faster. And now 3 men on this window, though. Not a great plan. However, they execute coming out already.
Well, look at Pengu in his position as well. They're going to wait for him to give the information, but he'll already get the kill on PSK. The C4 will get thrown in, but this is the problem now for Liquid. The Fuser's on the floor as they pick it right back up. Kanta Riketti taking a lot of damage. Nest gets one on Jonas. The spray from Kanta will not connect. There's still two players. See the Buck jumping in, but Penku's ready. And he'll swat him like a fly. Fabian is right below, though, and he'll be giving information if need be. But he'll go down to Nest. Nest is just going ham here. We've seen how strong he can be with runouts on the defense and also pure fragging power on the attack. Oh. And Nest yet again! He'll nail it on Pengu! Kanto, the last man alive, and can he do it? Low health on our Finnish player here. As you see, even the castle has given up on his life.
His phone's still ringing. But the plant has not gone down. 16 seconds left at this point.
This is definitely doable. It would have been a lot more doable if the Nitro Cell was not lost, but no, Sexy K comes in. We'll nail the last one. Round one of our third map will go the way of Team Liquid.
You saw the little handshake slash fist bump there between Nesk and Sexy Cake because, well, they carried that round. Nesk just dominating. He should have been slaughtered with those holes, but some great plays by Pengu as well on those stairs. Unfortunately, not great enough. Fantastic quick execute on the bomb site. They didn't even need to stick the plant because they got more than enough frags with all the time they had left with Sexy Cake, or I mean, Nesk, rather, controlling the bomb site for that long, getting away with it.
He just stands on there with little health. Yeah. And it will remind you, he's not even using the LMG with an angle grip, which would make it even easier for you to ADS quicker and get quick shots. He's using it with a standard grip, and he's still able to win 1v1 fights against some of the best 1v1ers in the world.
I gotta give a lot of credit, though, to that early grenade from the Buck, that execute on that, killing Goga, pretty much freed the path for Nesk to come swinging in the window, despite losing a friend in the process. That was what started the process early enough for them to have enough time to make that work. So great plays like that, great drone work, and not paying attention. Unfortunately, Goga just didn't see the drone and wasn't ready for it. Had he seen that, he might have known that they were going to be going for it. Did see them burning the ADSs, though. But either way, we will be going all the way down to the garage for Liquid, and Nesk going to be on dock this time. Trying to also channel that Kanto Riketti place. See if he goes for the spawn peek here.
Oh boy, Nesk again.
Freebie.
He's trying to tilt Penta off the face of the planet.
Well, unfortunately for him, they are busy on their drones at the moment. And as he starts to approach here, could it happen?
Goga!
The moment is approaching. He, nope, goes back on his phone to send a text, leaving Nesk wondering if this is worth it at this point. As he's about to
get he'll spot him. There you go.
Nicely done. He droned his own spawn peak.
We'll take a bit of damage in this one here, Nesk, but Goga has successfully passed
our test. Was that a mirror window on the garage door? That is a bold play, something we've seen mostly only from I Don't Know.
Oh yeah, IDK the way. Leon Gids, where are you at? We'll maybe see him one day at Pro League Finals.
We'll see if this is the way, as Kanto says Nesk is dead. So despite the early attempts to spawn peaks earlier, the rivals do once again battle, and is now advantage to Penta.
Yeah, Kanto Riketti winning out in this one here, but Bullet is still set in the Visa office. Sexy King close up. He's going to use the final black eye to get some information as Fabian should get spotted now. No, no, the pillar is hiding Fabian.
What a sneaky play.
I would have thought you needed a much bigger pillar to hide him, but is not the case here. Yunus will at least take down the barbed wire here. So maybe they can progress into the yellow stairs, and
there we go.
Exactly what they're going to do. He'll make the cross.
The take is happening here. They have control of piano and bathroom. This is going to be on Bullet to try and be a little surprise advantage here. Maybe catch Kanto while he's focused downstairs. As Fabian says, nope, not going to happen. This is all turning into an execute here, but Sexy Cake surprises Fabian for the trade, but that's only the Thatcher down, not the most important kill they need here to survive this.
Yeah, the four players still alive, and of course, Liquid have not brought a Bandit, they have not brought a Mute, so you know what, it doesn't really matter because the Thermite can still open up the garage wall.
Oh, no!
Oh boy, he'll hit it, Kanto! Onzig takes him out.
Lucky.
Unlucky. That was the mirror window as well that was taken down right in the middle. And now all that Penta have to do is deal with the last two players of Team Liquid, and they can open up top floor as well using the Buck of Kanto. They can use it up the open wall, so oh my god, Pengu with a shot long distance here. Type 89 is a spot. One dropping in, and that's Pengu with a second one as well. Get the kill with the Bearing 9.
Such a fast finish that was almost underwhelming. He just dropped down, swoop, you're dead. And that is the power of having control of the top floor. You know exactly where they're at. You know where they're playing. You can peek through all the floors thanks to Kanto opening it up. And all you have to do is drop ready to fire that. And Pengu's shown he's very ready to pre-fire on people like that. So they just needed to know he was dropping. But so many people left alive at that point. There was very little they could do. I mean, some good play by Sexy Cake sneaking up on them. Fortunately, that was pretty much the only good kill that they got that round. Now we'll see how Penta defend Garage. I imagine we're probably not going to see the Mirror Widow on the Garage door. Not that that really factored in too much, other than changing up a little bit of the execute. But we are again going to see a Vigil, this time from Kanto, something we've seen before. But Goga, instead of playing Jaeger, going to be going with Ella. It's definitely a different choice here we don't see often.
Yeah, maybe this time he is sick of just getting the assists and maybe wants to get a kill or two.
And you know, he's usually so good on that Jaeger, but you saw what happened first round when he was trapped around that corner and that grenade went off. Instead, he wants to be a little more flexible, a little less standing in a corner waiting for a grenade to kill him. However, that does mean they have no grenade coverage if it comes down to that. This is not necessarily a site where you need that so much, because most of the grenades just going to be used to clear wire on yellow stairs and get ready for pushes on the white van, things like that. Not anything that an ADS is going to help too much with, although it does prevent some grenades from coming down through the rafters, which, again, is not going to be a huge concern. They are going to set up some defenses in the bathroom, though. Looks like Peng is going to be throwing up a mirror window. They've got the hatch open and ready for a rotate if they need it. Could be Goga playing that.
One thing we won't see from Liquid is something we saw from Norarengu, actually, which was a Hibana with a supernova that blasts the wall open.
Yeah, and probably only going to see that from him. That is going to be his signature move for quite some time.
Japanese players playing a Japanese operator. I'm pretty sure that they know what they're doing.
Yeah.
Nesk is just going to try to get the spot here on the bandit that's hiding behind the black car. There we go. Drone is going to get taken down. It's very important to remove as much of the information as can be gathered by Team Liquid. Jonas has not gone in just yet for his bandit trick. PSK will try to trick him through that.
Oh, nice bait. Did not work, though. He went to go for the execute from the yellow stairs, and just the peaks are not timed well enough right now. And now you have Pengu standing up on the car, ready to help his buddy out. They are going to continue to trick this in a minute burned already.
Yeah, this is a spot that is very difficult even to see with a drone, because you don't really have that angle to play with. You can definitely hear PSK shuffling around if he wants to set up his exothermic charge.
The rest of the team really need to be doing something right here besides just standing around and droning, because you know what the defense is. Stop them from pushing you on yellow stairs and hold the wall. That's all they have to do. And that only takes two people here. The rest of the team need to be fighting there. But that grenade definitely did its job. And now Junas left in a tough spot. Eventually going to get that wall open, but costing them a minute 30, absolutely worth it. No one dead, no one took damage. Penta's still in a great spot here, as they have Kanto, who could be anywhere on the map at this point, as that Dark Knight.
Where is she?
Well, there he is indeed, going for a peek, making sure if they're trying to execute on that garage that maybe he can get them. And some nice support from Fabian, who's going to be able to call it where he can rotate. Phone call, going to be a little bit of a problem, but not a big deal for Kanto, who didn't even feel like he needed to answer it last time.
Oh no, the push from Liquid in the back. Pengu will get taken down as Sexy Cake rushes in. And there's still more. Candela's being shot in. Jonas cannot see a single thing as Nesk gets two more on the board here. What a play. It seems like Liquid realized we can't go from the front. We'll go in the back. Bolt with a team kill, but you know what? He'll get one more on Kanto. At least avenge his fallen comrade. Fabian has man alive with no C4 to play with. He's got to push up very close here to win the fight against Bolt. He'll take down at least one player. Sexy Cake low in health. He'll set up on the outside by the yellow stairs. It's PSK can just punch tiny holes open here to shoot through, as there's only basically a couple spots that Fabian can pen from. Get the kill. PSK will save the round. Round three will go the way of Team Liquid.
It's crazy how much time they spent trying to open that garage door.
And just
once
said,
they were ready
to
do it, yeah. Like, well, that's the thing, is that's the mind games right there. Once they did that, they know there's a thermite. They know that they're going to open that door. But they said, you know what? They're going to be thinking we're going to be opening that door that whole time. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to shoot them all in the back. And that's exactly what Nesk did. I mean, it's ironic enough that the team kill was on Nesk. Someone else wanted to get in on the action, but you know what? They did, and it worked out flawlessly, other than the one kill Fabian managed to get. And then, of course, was trapped by the line play. Great finish here by PSK, getting that last kill, so he can get a few frags in there, as he's not been exactly the top fragger, but it does not matter. He didn't even need to use that thermite. Did his job, though, in distracting them with that for as long as possible. So, well played, Nesk. Already up 5 kills. Pengu also on 4, and then 4 more share between Fabian and Kanto. So Fabian again going to be on that Thatcher, not the most critical role, but they are ready to open that garage as soon as need be. But guess what? No bandit, no mute. That garage door coming open without a minute 30 to burn, and then they can be ready to execute from behind if need be. And Kanto, of course, again, going to be ready to buck open the floor. Maybe they just decided Kanto's too good playing that buck and piano. Let's just go ahead, spend our resources on something else. We'll put Nesk on a 3-speed death machine and see if he can go loose with Bullet and Sexy to get those flanks that we need, as Sexy's gonna set up a lot of open windows here, really make them question where the spawn feeds could be coming from, especially after you saw Nesk actually set up for one. They do know that it's entirely possible from Liquid.
One thing that you didn't mention before in our previous match is that a lot of times now in Consulates, teams will just play only one camera on the outside and let the rest just be played inside.
Getting a lot more conservative because of IQ.
Yep, yep, exactly. Because you pretty much always will see an IQ every round.
Which is funny because technically IQ didn't get any buffs. Just all of a sudden people started to see the utility of it.
Yep.
Now everyone's playing it. But they are going to go again with that mirror window on the garage door, which last time they didn't really mess with too much. They seem to struggle with it. And Goga is going to potentially get set up to go to open that either way. But he is going to be the defuse carrier. So if they need to rotate around to a different side, Goga's going to have to join them. Kanto is trying to slowly creep his way towards taking control of Piano, but very concerned about Visa pushes. The rest of his teammates aren't backing him up right now. He should not be fighting this alone because it is important that he's able to open that floor. We just saw what they did for them last time. So Junas needs to maybe stop spending his time shooting things outside, help his team inside so that Goga cannot be sitting duck out here.
Nobody jumping out. I mean, no. Remember, remind you of Nesk back in the day when he jumped out of the window and got 2k at least.
Knows Kanto's right there. It's all about timing here. He's just waiting for the right moment. Oh, the drone finds him though. Not going to happen just yet. But he doesn't know about the camera that is placed down there. And that is the critical piece of information here, as you just mentioned about the inside cameras being a lot more of a thing, especially on a big map like this, where there's some flexibility to rotate around. The lack of top floor control here does bother me a little that Penta aren't even worrying about it and are just letting Sexy Kick hang out upstairs. But look how much time they're spending watch hatches. All of this time watching hatches could be used on the execute, but a minute left to do so.
Oh, Kanto just continuing to open up the floorboard. A Sexy Kick from above has still not been fought.
Now,
Pengu's waiting for him. If he wants to push in from one side or the other. Oh, what is going on? Zig will go down to the headshot. Nobody moving through on Jonas as he's still alive with little HP. But Sexy Kick gets one. Kanto, Pengu with a refrag. Bullet with a refrag again on Pengu. What is happening here? Kills being traded here. And back and forth between the two. 32 seconds left on the clock as Ness will get one more. He'll get the second one as well with a drop. And Bullet with the last one. Penta on the floor. Oh my god. This is getting close. Team Liquid. Third round on the board. We're two rounds away, possibly, from crowning the first ever Latin American champion.
I do feel like Penta don't know what to do with some of these plays. You saw how much time they spent looking upstairs instead of taking upstairs. You saw Kanto walking in all alone. You saw Sexy and Bullet there just being able to do whatever they want. And those, you saw the flanks from upstairs, and the Nesk able to sit down here in that tiny little spot we see a lot more players playing now with perfectly timed executes. The flexibility from Liquid.
I just don't want to see Zig cry at the end because I know he gets very emotional at the end of these kinds of games.
Could we see Fabian cry at the end for once?
Nah.
Nah, probably not.
Nah, probably not. Maybe.
Wishful.
I mean, Zoronic, you know, threw a punch or two on the analysis desk, but you know what? It's Alex. He can do whatever he wants.
To be fair, Justin did too. Oh, the setup coming up here for the defense again for Garage. No one's played lobby yet. Despite that being such a prevalent bomb site, they are not using that. And Pentar team that will potentially pull that out all of a sudden on the other team when it's least expected. But I'm starting to wonder if Penta might be considering using that other timeout soon here, the way things are going. A lot of defense being set up on this bathroom yet again.
Honestly, I think that timeout should have already been used, like right now.
Yeah, it's definitely the tipping point here, potentially. But we did see a similar position last time on Border, and that came precariously close to a Penta win as well, despite this slow start. So, I don't feel like Penta are too down mentally on this. They are more than capable of being like, that's fine. Every round is a reset, I feel like, to them at this point. And it's definitely working out, but they still have to at least get one more soon. Or this could go to match point, and match point's a very tough place to be. No supernova needed there, thanks to Zig.
Thanks to Zig. Well, at least right now, the coaches are happy, the players are happy from Team Liquid, and I'm pretty sure the late Internet Hulk, Dennis Havelka, is watching from up above. And he's looking at Team Liquid, he's proud of them right now. And maybe they'll be able to be victorious here against their bitter rivals, Penta Sports. Team Liquid now trying to take control of the top floors, Kanto Rocchetti is upstairs trying to go for a quick peek. There's nobody through in the console office. You see everything has been barricaded just in case Liquid wanted to go for a quick push. Now, E1D will get used. That is the first one here in the round at a minute 39. UNS will get spotted as he runs all the way back, and they will take down the thermite. Well, the charge that is actually thrown onto the wall here by the Havana.
There's a lot of time being spent trying to get that bathroom clear, and because Kanto's holding those stairs as well, I think this is a good defense. If they can continue to bait them into fighting the bathroom, this could work similar to what we saw last round, although Kanto taking a lot of damage, forced to rotate, and Fabian still hanging out downstairs in the archives. Unfortunately, not going to be doing a whole lot just yet other than calling out the positioning for his teammates. But Nesk is still alive. Everyone's still alive at the last minute here. They're going to start opening hatches and getting ready to drop down. Start putting pressure downstairs as the upstairs is cleared out.
All right. Well, drones are going to be in here. Skanto can get reset. Not sure if that will happen, though. Fabian will fall to Nesk yet again. He just sprays on in. What is happening here at Penta Sports? This is definitely not the dominating team that we're used to in the past. Pengu will get blinded here as he moves the way back. C4 will get thrown up, but Pengu will get taken down before he can do much. Jonas, though, getting the kill on Nesk. Can it actually help them out here, or is it too little, too late for Penta? PSK gets one more, two left alive. Kanto, remember, low on health as Jonas will hold the back angle. Buck has already opened the wall in the back, and Team Liquid, a flurry of the two at the end. They're one round away from being crowned the new champions of Pro League.
At this point, I want to call a timeout for Penta.
Can we force a timeout at this point?
My goodness, if they're not using it at this point, they need to really have their heads in the game. This could be history in the making.
What?
Those trophies.
They're so close, yet still so far. You know, you can say one round, but oh boy.
Here we go, Lobby.
You know what?
Just Lobby coming out from Liquid.
Just listen to these guys for just a second.
They are excited, and even if they lose this round. A few fans.
Yeah, dabbing not allowed, but I think that's one thing we should have not allowed in here. And there you go. We'll see if Liquid dabs on Penta at the end of this one here.
So this is the surprise defense I was mentioning earlier about Lobby being played here. If Penta are not prepared for this, that's it. Penta are done. However, this could also be one of their weaker bomb sites. So this could be potentially an easy round for Penta, giving them that comeback momentum that they need. So this is a little bit of a gamble here from Liquid on this match point. But hey, that's when you gamble sometimes if you're that far ahead. Look at these kills coming out from everyone on Liquid, as well as the zero, unfortunately, from Goga.
Now, FaZe Clan are watching right here, right now, among the crowd. They're seeing their teammates, their ex-teammates, if you will, as well, of Team Liquid, and they're very happy with the performance. I assume the phase-ups have turned into a Go Liquid here. Mira Takavala for all the Brazilians that might be watching. But Team Liquid on the defense, they're going to bring their Legion. And Legion, we've said how important he is to shut down every single one of these stairs, even setting up a couple of his goo mines. On the other side by Admin, Zig on the pulse yet again. We'll see the smoke of PSK, Sexy Cake on his Valkyrie again, and Nesk on the Jaeger this time around. Maybe the signals are rush. Jonas and Penta have to be very, very careful here. All it takes is a few kills and everything can go sour.
Nicely done. Junus playing very, very carefully this time to get those cameras. They need to approach. Oh, so look at this. At this point, crawling through the jungle of safety. But the spawn peak potential here from Sexy Cake, he knows he's outside because the camera's down now. He knows that someone's outside hunting cameras, which gives him the opportunity to catch him off guard with all those pre-opened window spots. Gonna check what cameras he has left. Nothing spotted there, but he does know that there's someone near the front door, and he takes a peek. No one's standing that close, as Junus is actually baiting it out at this point. Oh, the shots just grazing his head. This is the rivalry between these two happening right now. The tension mounts, but Ness cuts him with a knife on the Kanto Rakete.
Welcome to the jungle, Penta Sports. That's the first kill, and even Jonas is down. Two technical kills here for Team Liquid. Maybe Jonas can be picked up, but his position is precarious. Sexy Cake peeks, but Bolt will get the kill on Goga. Here's the cleanup from Sexy Cake. Two alive, Pengu and Fabian. Is this the downfall?
In the making, Fabian, last man alive, the in-game leader on the Lion. He'll have to roar.
OP is Lion here to fight five. Good luck, Fabian.
Everybody from Team Liquid concentrating their efforts. You see everybody, every single one of the players here concentrating on the one kill that they need. Have they run out?
Yes, they will! Liquid, they win! Latin America,
Penta goes down!
Finally, Latin America is triumphant. They couldn't do it in Katowice. They could not do it at Gamescom. They could not go and do it even in Brazil, in Sao Paulo.
Welcome to the Americas, Penta.
Welcome, the American dream. It has happened right here in Atlantic City. And this is Team Liquid, the victors, the champions. Penta have been finally put to bed.
Put your shoes back on, Fabian. No interview for you this time. Well done. Look at Ness right there. Showing up for Steve. Look at the tears in these guys' eyes. They cannot even believe they made it. Having two coaches might have paid off here. Unfortunate for FaZe. Look at that. Nesk can barely stand up at this point.
If you asked me, Nesk is the MVP of this entire tournament. Let's give Team Liquid a round of applause. Nesk, PSK, Bullet, Sexy Cake, and Zig. This team is absolutely insane. Their coaching staff is happy. And yes, as I said it before, Dennis Havelka, Internet Hulk, is looking from above in heaven, and he's proud, he's happy. Team Liquid have been dominant in every single esport, and here in Rainbow Six, they're repeated. But remember, it's all about respect, it's all about love and trust here. That's the best thing about esports, that's the best thing about CG Sports. And if anything, these two teams are fans of one another. They love their plays, but this is what they're playing for, and Team Liquid will now have a spot for this one trophy.
I think they're having fun now.
I think they're having fun. Well, at least this time, that shelf for Fabian and the team will be dusty for at least one more season. We'll get to see. Though, before that, we'll remind you that DreamHack Austin is coming up in 2 weeks. If you're going to be in Austin, let us know, because it's going to be a ton of fun. It's going to be mostly North American teams, but we'll have BYOC teams coming in as well. Four of them, four European teams. After that, Paris Major. Before that, we have the DreamHack Valencia. There is so much esports still, but Matt, take it away and take this one on as Maestro has blessed you. Please give it up. Give it up one more time for Team Liquid.
We have a standing ovation here in Atlantic City, and well deserved. The moment that final round was won, the whole place was on its feet. Well done, you, Atlantic City. Well done, Team Liquid. We have to give our appreciation for that final to their fallen opponents. Ladies and gentlemen, the legends that are Penta Sports. Pengu clapping back, and I know you guys would be the first to lead that applause for them. Zig, come here. This is fun.
This is fun, man. I'm dreaming.
We know it always matters to you. We always see you like this. We know it's hard. We can joke around on this stage. We can say it's games. Of course it should be fun. But it's competition, and it matters. And look how much it matters to you.
I'm too excited, you know. I'm not believing. That was amazing. We trained so hard. Yeah. Far out.
I'm going to let you have this. It's been a long time coming. Latin America have finally earned it. These guys are the ones who've taken it. Ladies and gentlemen, we wait no longer. The new Pro League champions are Team Liquid. Absolutely unbelievable. I want to talk to more of you now. I want to know how this feels. Sexy Cake, you're the champion of season 7.
I don't know. I don't know what to say, man. It's so good, man.
You know how much this matters to Brazil. You know how much this matters to the whole region. Come up here. Tell me something about how much this matters to you. Your boys have done it.
Yes, guys, we did it. I can't believe that it happened, but thank you for all the crowd here. You guys are amazing. Without you guys, we're nothing. Without you guys, we are nothing. That's true. The Brazilian fans, principally for these guys.
Everywhere we go, Latin America brings it. Everywhere we go, the Brazilian fans are amazing, and the North Americans, and the Europeans, and the APAC ones as well. You guys are loud, and your boys have done it. Team Liquid are the season 7 champions.